a mistake was letting myself get attached.
That's fair. Your tattoo?
No, attached.
What? Oh.
To his father.
I thought you said my mistake was getting a tat.
I have a tattoo.
Yeah, but I mean, I thought you got a tattoo of Devlin.
Oh, maybe.
My freaking Twitch is doing that thing.
There's a local guy that prints...
A local guy?
Like 3D prints miniatures.
Oh.
I'm kind of tempted to get a Devlin one made. Hi, Lauren.
Hello.
Probably old camera. Still connected to work. What is this song? Why have I put this on?
You look so cute, breathable today.
Thank you. I haven't even turned my camera on.
Who are you talking to?
Not you. Adam.
What? Oh.
Who did you think I was talking to?
I don't know.
Me.
Anybody else, please.
Anyone else.
Right.
All right. Hang on, I was thinking for a watch together before.
Yeah, I'm just putting
so
it in now.
Rude, not rudely, but just deeply looks distracted. So
plump and breathable. What? Okay. Where is the general? Because I always put it in the wrong one. Here it is.
Oh, gosh.
I've forgotten where the D&D notebook has gone once more. I put it down, and I found two.
Is it grey?
It's not the one you're looking at, which has somehow made its way there.
I don't know how it's there either.
I do. It's called EU. It's like a black leather one with Fashion Retail Academy written on the side of it.
Oh, yeah, I don't know what that is.
Oh, yeah, I know the one. No idea where that is.
Do you know where it is?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Where?
It's in the other place.
No, it's definitely been in this place.
You sure?
I never seen all the other place I'm thinking of.
Yeah. It'll be the last place you look.
Like, yeah. Down the sofa.
Lauren, you're so right. It used to be the first place I looked, because I knew exactly where things were. That's
and then I got married, and now I can't find anything!
Oh, this awesome. One I brought home with me from your flat.
It's just full of all my D&D notes. Oh, I actually told my D&D notes on one side and then a mental health awareness course on the other side.
I've just flicked all the way to the back page, crossed out whatever rubbish ending you had, and then said, and Devlin saves the day, and everybody rejoice.
Right, let's get your dice ready. We all in the chat?
And no.
The watch the room in. God, it's pretty old work computer.
Has everyone tested their luck ahead of time?
No.
Yeah,
I was going to send a message early into the chat. I was like, everyone bless your dice tonight. Except
nice.
Alex.
Top 10. The good stuff.
Okay, I rolled a 1 as my first roll of the night. Let's see how Nubbins is going to do. A 19.
1 as well.
Oh, Nubbins.
That sounds about right.
Oh,
Nubbins, all the good stuff happens to him.
Although I used the wrong dice. The wrong dice? God, no.
Oh my god, we're all fucking. Chess has got us all saying it now.
I used the wrong dice for the wrong characters. Uh
oh. Oh no, Nubbins.
Wait, does Nubbins have his own dice?
He does.
Nubbins needs the dice. I've got a song that'll bless your dice for you. It's been in Dan's mind this entire time.
No, fuck off.
I can't hear it.
Neither can I.
You're not missing out.
I can.
Is it on the watch tier?
Oh yeah. Oh, I can.
Oh, it's kicked in there.
Does Dan love this song?
Yeah, it's Dan's favorite song. Big man, blast toys. Big man, blast toys. Big man, blast toys.
Dan does not approve this message.
Fuck, you're just embarrassing yourself now.
Well, you're all fucking 30, aren't you? No one's having a good blast toys time, are we?
I don't have a good blast toys time. I've got a blast toys right here. Huh.
can always rely on Tom to enjoy being there, Blaster.
How dare you accuse me of being 30?
Damn.
Right.
I've never heard that song before, but I'm on board.
No, you just follow what Alex is doing, and Alex follows what you're doing. No surprise there.
How dare you?
I would never.
I'm sitting on my Discord between the two of you, and you're both going like this. I'm just like, why?
No, we got a miniature of Lauren made in Japan.
That's good.
Right. Everyone ready?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Previously.
You not started yet?
Facts.
So, last episode. What an eventful episode that was, and a long one as well. If we all remember, it was a double bill. And so we'll start with the amazing parade, basically a Roman triumph all the way to the castle grounds. Beautiful grounds.
Excellent grounds, the best grounds you've ever seen.
And you go in, and there's everyone, like all the nobility from Midland, some of the nobility from Antia. Max is dropping a load of pipes. And as you enter the castle, there's full of tapestries everywhere, priceless artworks, priceless statues, these beautiful ornate paintings. Some as big as the
burn it all.
Yeah, the keep walls, and obviously there's the dance. The Vonheims were there, which some of you were immediately suspicious about, and very intrigued on discovering more, both physically and information wise. And eventually, you all went to dinner, had a good mingle time. You know, you all sat apart. Everyone was having a good old time. But the Vonheims left a little bit earlier. They had their own plans. Maybe they had a plane to catch. But they left a bit early. Devlan immediately had followed their guards first, and snuck aboard their ship. Angel and Clara were actually invited back with them, and they accepted. They got in their little carriage and went with them. Back on the ship, Devlan had to disguise himself as a child in order to escape the suspicions. Angel and Clara went to Pound Town and swang a little. Well, swang? Were swinging a bit. They swang some wang, and there was you know, just some body pumping action on the other side of the door that Devlan had to try and pretend to sleep through after three meals back to back. Angel then left the room. Nubbins had managed to steal one of Alexandra's blue crystal, which is this ornate, almost like a pointed diamond, a bit like this dice here, but solid blue. And very like misty on the inside, very suspicious, but you've seen that she's got four giant wands on either side of, well, two on the front and back of her ship. You also discovered a secret door and leading to a secret compartment where Casanova, the somewhat brutally, I guess, tortured, but he was missing almost all his limbs. He had one arm, and he was like missing eyes, and had been like his skin had been peeled back, and he was pumped into all this like purple goopy machine, but he was able to control puppets with. Angel and Clara rescued him from his capture and began to leave the ship alongside Devlan, who had snuck out the porthole after regurgitating his three meals, only to discover that Asriel was there. And so a three-way fight has begun with Angel, Devlan, and now Gerwar versus the Vonheims versus Asriel. Little triangle fight. Clara has successfully escaped with Casanova, but she did obviously leave most of her clothes. Nubbins has the blue crystal, and all shit is going loose. This massive dock has been destroyed by the light. It's like crumpling under the weight of these huge snakes. Most of the blue light crystals have been taken out. One of the operators was Devlan's adopted father, who was crushed between the ship and the dock when the snake smashed into it. One snake has managed to get on board, and the crew are all like stabbing at it. and there are these like heavy armored, almost like draconic looking knights. So they've got these weird like leathery bat winged helms, and they're aboard the ship as well with sword, shield and axes, trying to fight Angel right now. Angel, you're shirtless, even though it's snowing outside, so your nipples are extremely erect. And you've got your Tanto, and that's the only weapon you've got right now.
I don't think I do have it, because my note specifically tells me I don't have my Tanto in Azrael's mask, apparently. Because I think.
Yes, you stabbed him in the statue in the face again.
And then it just sealed
in
it. I thought in I did have a shirt on. I got changed and left.
Oh, maybe then. Maybe, my bad.
Not to ruin the image. I'm sure it's still really cold.
And then there are like three or four crewmen like loading rifles ready to shoot down in the decking at Angel. The anchor's being raised, the sail has been lowered. They're clearly planning on fleeing sometime soon. There is one blue turret still operational. Gerwal, you're rushing back. You've just alerted the guards, but you're rushing back with two of the muskets. Alexandra von Heim, or Lady von Heim, is still in the air with these big leathery bat wings, firing all kinds of magic down at you, and Alexander von Heim is just going like 1v1ing Azrael as the two of them are just tearing chunks out of one another repeatedly. Any questions about that part? Devlan, you're on the dock right now as well. I've got six. You're off the ship.
Nubbins just blasted some guards, correct?
Oh, Nubbins. No, that was a while back. Nubbins did use this Spartan laser crystal, and it like cut three of the guards in half. But now one guard is chasing him across the decking with a spear, just like jabbing at him repeatedly as Nubbins is going, oh fuck, as he's like carrying the crystal and running.
So I guess my only question is, weapon wise I know I don't have a Tanto, but do I still have everything else, because I did sort of equip myself
I think you've got your whip. Yeah, you've all you have is your belt, which is your whip.
What, the chain?
Yeah.
Okay,
that's it.
All right.
Sorry, you've got your hidden blade.
Yeah, okay.
You haven't got your chain, you've only got your hidden blade.
Okay.
How far away is Gerwat in terms of time?
Like 3 minutes sprint. You didn't make it that far before you found a guard.
Okay.
But yeah, I imagine you got two rifles and a pocket full of powder and lead.
Nice.
Back in the keep, Reiner and his infinite wisdom fired a flare out of the dining hall and into the main hall, which has caused a massive fire to start on the roof. Inside the hall, so bits of timber and painting and tapestry are like dropping down. This whole hall is not quite smoky just yet, but like it's raining ash and fire. Xylus has summoned his entire armor. He has the brother armor to Voltrim, and is able to control earth with beyond the skill of any earth mage user that ever has existed. He's also a trained assassin and extremely skilled in combat. None of you have armor on, except for Voltrim, and pretty much all of you are unarmed, except for like Castle Forge steel that you grabbed off the wall, perhaps. And that's it. You guys are trying to fight him. Five Templars rushed in. Two are dead.
I have leather armor, and I have my weapon.
You have your sword, yeah. And I don't think you have armor.
Up right now?
Huh?
I thought other people brought their swords.
No.
One weapon.
Voltrim has his axe.
Mm. Yeah, Voltrim will have his axe because he summoned it.
Yeah.
And his armor. But yeah, right now, Xylus is back against the wall. There are a bunch of musketmen standing with Leaf and Miranda about to let loose a volley. Cassian is kind of guarding them on one side of his long sword. Freya, you've just been thrown across the room from what I can remember. But you landed on your feet. He summoned a dust storm around him, and there are two Templars left with their like mace and shield. Hawk is there alongside. I was going to call him Giles for some reason, but he's definitely not called Giles. He is called Garion. To be confused with Evil Garion. And Hawk are there, and so is Lysandra. She's got her axe, but no armor. And Neose, but no armor. And Draven.
Esmeralda's still alive, right? She was the one who Silas
She's kind of just in there. Oh, no. Is she dead?
I can't remember.
No, I thought she just got like knocked out.
Oh yeah, she might just be knocked out, yeah. Alright, are we all ready?
I think so. Where the Ice Mage, is he still...
Hawk, yeah, he's still in the main hall.
Oh, he's still there. And what about Aaron Oakheart? Was he there at the party?
Yeah, but he would have evacuated the people and got them out.
Because he could help with the fire. Okay, that's it, I'm done.
Okay. Right, we're going to start off in the main hall. So I hope you're all ready. That's the wrong one. There we go. So, back against the one of the pillars, he's got a massive dust storm summoned, his silver and white armor, his helmet all the way down. Miranda's like, get out the way to Lulan and Voltrim. As you see, there's a kneeling line and a standing line of rifles. Get out the way! Miranda shouts
again.
I'm
gonna get out the way.
Nice.
He's gonna lie down.
You duck down. There's this like... as all these like musket shots fire, like, smoke fills the hall as they all this sand just arises into a wall and all the bullets get caught into it, and then their bullets like burst outwards and everyone kind of ducks around, and Xylas rushes forward summoning the storm back round himself. A fireball comes from Neos's hand, it's blocked by the sandstorm. A fireball from Lysandra, it's blocked by the sandstorm. I haven't got my notes about turn order. This is very frustrating.
Let's reset it.
Alright, let's reset. Everyone roll.
Also, I think you might be in the drawers in your little unit under the desk.
No, it's not.
I haven't got any dice.
Oh dear.
I'll roll for you, Max.
Ow.
If you trust me to. I'll get you a special dice.
I like time of that.
Yeah,
let's get a selection out.
You're ready to roll?
Yeah.
One sec, I'm just letting Max choose a dice.
Oh no, just pick the most rhino one.
Green, orange, black.
Green.
Yeah, let's go green.
Actually,
green
I don't know
Max.
Where that notebook is.
Green. Maybe orange for the fire that he's unleashed.
That's 18.
I feel like things have just been moved without us there. Maybe Dan's just like... picked random things in the house and just like
taking it home.
Suddenly moved them.
I don't know why, but oh my god.
Flashback.
Help! There we go. I'm just going to put the time order on the notepad. Right. Roll for me. Roll for me, my mate. Roll.
I think he got an 18 from what I heard.
Who?
Rhino, no? I don't know. I joined up.
Okay.
I got 17.
Okay,
I
so
got 16.
Okay, so weird so far. Rhino, Freya, Poulin, Voltrum?
3.
Okay, well that's pretty easy. Voltrum.
Yeah, I was lying about that one.
So, Rhino into Xylas, into Freya, into Xylas, into Lulan, into Xylas. Cool. Rhino, you're first. What do you want to do? You see, you're standing midway through the hall. Embers are falling down around you, and you see he's like rushing with this sandstorm around him towards Miranda and the rifleman.
If I remember correctly, I've just used Wind Wall, and Wind Wall is still up.
Yep.
I also just used my ring.
Yep.
He's walking towards Miranda.
Running, yeah.
Can I use windset?
Yep. Roll a windset.
Can I windset?
Yep. Do you know your perk sheet or anything like that? Your skills?
Oh yeah, I do actually.
All right. Roll a wisdom.
Popped. Oh, 19.
All right, he passes it. You wind step successfully. Wow. Did you want to wind step to Miranda or him?
Go to Miranda.
Cool. You appear next to Miranda. She's
now. Whoa, wait. The wind wall stays up where it's placed.
Yeah.
Or does it move? Yeah.
No,
it okay, stays cool. up. That's fine.
Ryder, as you like appear next to her.
Can I pick up something from the floor and chuck it at him?
Yeah. Yeah, what do
you want to do? Run away from Miranda.
Yeah.
Whatever's on the floor nearest me, like a rock or a goblet or something.
Yeah, there's a tankard on the floor. Roll a dex. Adam?
Oh, sorry. I keep forgetting
his name. Two. You go to throw the mug of ale. It's still got some ale in it, and you just splash one of the guards from behind you. And he's like, ah! Ah! As it splashes him in the eyes. Silas's turn. He just continues, like, you just look at the mug. Silas continues running, but the two Templars jump into the sandstorm, and you see their armor light start to light up as it blocks the magic. And they're walking through it towards him. He's kind of startled by this, but they're going to swing their weapons. One hits. Another hits. Armor. Blocks. Blocks. So their two maces slam into his chest, but it stopped him for the part time. He's going to try and counter by punching one of them. He misses. Second attack. And he misses again. So the two Templars are alive. Freya.
So where is thrown?
You were just thrown into a pillar and you're next to Lysandra and Iose on like the far end.
Okay, and he's got a sandstorm around him, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Okay, which is pretty useless. Well, it's pretty bad for Freya because sand puts fire out. Okay, and she's got no weapons. Is there anything I can use?
Like... as far as you can see, the closest set of weapons are like some swords hung up on the wall, like all these like ornamental weapons hanging up, but they're possibly operational. Some look a bit rusted, but hard to tell with the fact that smoke is slowly filling the room.
Can I go on Overwatch then?
Sure. You got your fireball on Overwatch or your small fireballs?
The big fireball.
Okay. Silas's turn. He is going to swing again at these two Templars. It's a hit. That's a miss. So the first Templar swings again. Silas like ducks under, grabs his arm, and just snaps his arm. The armor breaks and all this sand flushes into the armor. And you see the guy go, his like skins explode. And it's just bone and skeleton and muscle visceral is like he falls face down. The other Templar's gonna swing. And Silas just Barton kicks him straight out the sandstorm, and he like catapults and rolls against the wall, but lands and places his shield up as a load of bricks and earth hits his shield. Silas continues walking towards Leaf, Cassie, and Miranda and the firing squad. Lulan, your turn.
God, I'm gonna. Does Reiner have his earpiece? I can't remember. Or if he gave that away.
No, he gave it to Tom.
Fuck. Okay. I'm pretty fucking useless in this shit.
I would argue that you're possibly the only one who isn't useless at this point.
Oh no. So I have any sort of like kind of, I don't know, immunity to sand just because like my people? Or am I okay?
No, you're not. No. You have no immunity to sand.
Well, shit. Okay, in my notes it says I have 8 tokens now, but if that is true, then I want to use, Radcoffin on him.
Yeah, okay, alright. Lulan, like, stands there channeling for a second as all this blood begins to, like, seep out of her paws, out of, like, her pouch, her jam jar, as she's standing there and this, like, massive wave of blood, like, circles her. Repeatedly forming this almost like a vortex, and then it flushes out across the ground, almost moving almost like a snake would as it moves towards its target. After Spartan kicking, he's just summoned a load of bricks that have flown towards the Templar who's blocked of his shield, and suddenly this blood comes up from the ground while he's distracted. Roll a d20 for me.
No. 18 and 15, sorry, it's yellow. 18.
He's lifted up off the ground. as this blood kind of wraps around him, the sand is now getting damper and damper as bits of like clumps of sand hit the floor, and you've lifted him into the air as you're kind of holding your arm out, guiding the blood. Does it say how much wounds it does?
5.
All right.
And it keeps him in the air.
Yep. He's now in suspended animation for one turn. So he misses his turn, which is now, and now Voltrum, your turn.
Okay, how far away from Freya am I?
You've just ducked from the musket fire, so if you stand up, you're in between Xylus and the musket line behind you.
Okay. I think given the fact he's elevated off the ground, this is our like best chance we've had in freaking ages. So I want to ignite with lightning the axe and throw it to try and like punch a hole through the barrier and hit the guy.
His sand barrier's fallen now because of the blood.
Nice.
Oh, even better. Okay, yeah.
Can I also do with Adam?
Yep.
Fireball.
So you're on the left hand side
do
of
it last.
You're on the left hand side of Xylus. So you like summon your fireball, Voltrum stands up, ignites the axe, and then like overhand goes, and goes straight through the blood coffin and out the other side, and it slams into the pillar, goes through the pillar, and smashes a mirror behind it as it digs into a castle wall. All this glass shatters down as suddenly Freya just goes and fires this huge blue fireball, which slams into the side of the blood, causing this like mist, this almost red mist to appear as it superheats the blood. And then there's just like bump as this body hits the floor.
Annoying. Fucking triple combo.
Question. Do I get a fire token for that?
You do.
I will follow that up. To try and like close the distance, yep. So that he's then focused on me.
Yeah, he's like standing up on one leg. He's sopping wet and covered in blood.
I think I can call the axe back to me for an action, but I'm gonna hold, and I want to basically like prepare to be like a grapple or fighting, like in hand to hand, like go strength to strength with this guy.
Yeah,
I know I'm gonna win, but I kind of want to do it.
As you're doing that, this ice spear just goes straight over your head and it slams into his shoulder and he slides back in the blood. And you see that Hawk is moving towards the right-hand side of him to block the main hall door, eating area door that you've just come from.
Does Xylus look scared or is it just shield?
It's just like a pot helmet, so you can't really tell.
Okay.
Cassian also slides forwards. He's next to you with his curved elvish longsword, and he's in preparation and in defense formation. As Xylus is slowly standing, there's another massive, like this beast, it looks like a three-headed lion, made of fire, just pounces from above, bringing down a load of embers within. It slams into the floor, exploding this castle floor, bricks and dust and debris go everywhere. And then following it is Lysandra holding this axe, and she's swinging, and you see that Xylus is ducking and dodging and rolling around. The Templar stands as well as she's like forcing him towards the Templar. No idea what you had your eyes on the Osei Freya, but he's vanished into the like the darkness. He's somewhere waiting for a surprise attack. Xylus's turn. Lysandra brings down the axe and he like grabs it with two hands and the blade is just inches away from his helmet and she's forcing it down. Her hands are on fire, the blade's on fire, and he slams it into almost into his shoulder and it scrapes off one of the plodrons, which like smashes into the floor. But you notice it kind of like coil down and it disappears into the earth. He then is just going to kick her in the knee. So she goes down to one knee. She does a wide swing. He rolls backwards, and the Osei jumps on his back, and starts like he puts his hand on the guy's pot helmet and just engulfs it in fire as all the fire is going into the gap. There is a moment Rykar, that Voltrim, you can feel this like, and you know that the armor is charging for something big.
Do I have a chance to do anything?
Yes, you can shout or rush, or you've got one action, a bonus action now.
Can I ult him?
Which one?
The one to take him away.
Oh, okay.
So that whatever he unleashes is unleashed in that kind of realm.
So Niose is thrown backwards. The Templar catches him as the two of them smash into the wall. And this like puff of smoke just separates Cassian. Cassian's also knocked to the side. The musketmen that were behind you get knocked backwards. Reiner, you and Miranda are like, "Oh, the fuck?" As you're like brushed backwards by the storm cloud. And he stands up beside you, or opposite you. And he like clicks his neck, takes off his helmet, and you see that this one side of his face is like completely burnt. His eyes sealed shut. "Brother," a voice comes from the helmet. The bear, Voltrim, like opens the clouds and stands almost beside Rykar / Aegis. "Brother," it says, as lightning bolts kind of like explode out of its mouth. And you see the helmet, this mist appear. It's almost like a mohawk of stone. It looks almost like a mountain ridge. And there's a flash memory of when these guys weren't sealed in armor. And a giant bear's descending from the sky with like this huge, like your original ult, your first ult. And then there's this, what's it? A lynx? What's the mythical beast that's lion, goat?
Can't remember what it's called. Chimera.
Chimera, yeah. There's like a earth chimera standing at the top of this mountain, and it jumps, and the two of them collide. Inside this ult, obviously, Rykar, you're gonna probably rush him. Like, well, it's for you to say.
Yeah, yeah. Let's leave them to it. I'm just gonna go and try and just punch him in the face.
Yeah, you're now having just a plain fist fight. The two of you are wailing at each other. In the background, this chimera and bear are just tearing at each other. Chunks of the mountain, chunks of these clouds and lightning bolts explode around you. You're wailing on one another repeatedly. Some solid punches in. You will recognize that in hand-to-hand combat, he is leagues ahead of Rykar and Aegis. Okay. And is on a whole other level in hand-to-hand.
The idea is just to let whatever he was charging go off here and then return. Even if we lose, it's fine. As long as that doesn't hurt everyone else.
So you hear this like, boop, 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 and he slams the helmet back on, and these chimera eyes appear, and you're frozen to stone.
Oh.
So you're completely sealed into stone. The ult dissipates immediately. So all of you guys standing there, you would have just seen smoke appear and seen this bolt of lightning and earth with like popping out occasionally. And now suddenly, not just Rykar is frozen, but you see this like ghost formation that would be coming out of Rykar's back, completely frozen as well.
Is he like top heavy?
He's like seesawing. No, he's frozen completely to the floor in like a battle stance.
Okay.
And standing there is Xylus.
It would probably be like a block or something.
Probably. Roll for coolness of how good you look in stature.
13.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Reiner, your turn.
Can I see any of like the archmages? Are they stuck around or anything like that? Any old mages?
There's only one archmage, which is Hawk. The rest were Templar, and there's one left at plus Garion.
Can I ask Hawk if he knows what's happened?
Yeah, say it.
Hawk, what's happened? Why is Rykar stone?
I don't know. I don't know what's growing out of his back. I need to go and I need to go get near them. Get me near them. He like rushes to your side and he puts his hands like that and two ice blades appear out of his hands.
Okay. I'll charge the big guy.
Cool. you've got your longsword. Did you want to like rush him with a longsword attack or your short sword even?
I want to rush him, attack, but just before I attack, I want to lay a wind trap behind me, and then attack, prepare to dodge back.
All right, that's going to be a dex roll. That'll be two dex rolls, I'm going to say. Adam, first to see
three.
Okay.
Second one is a three.
Okay.
Can I maybe have a reroll on that one?
That's I'll allow you to have a reroll, given the situation is that...
it's a two! You're...
Okay. So you swing, yeah. And he casually ducks it. Your trap doesn't go off, so you've still got that in your wisdom inventory. But yeah, your first attack misses. You get one more action.
Casey has confiscated that dice.
Nice.
Good.
can I wing kick him?
Yes. Roll of wisdom.
12.
Yeah, you wing kick him and he slides across the room. He manages to keep his composure and you fall backwards onto Niosei and the Templar, who like catch you as you land. Actually, Niosei doesn't catch you, he just lets you smash into the wall. Niosei just steps underneath you as you slam into it.
Prick.
Hawk's like kind of running. Hawk's running his hands over Voltrum. It's some sort of a paralyzation spell. Whatever that charging was, whatever Voltrum tried to defend us from, we've got to watch out from him. Activate, and then he rushes Hawk, smashes Hawk right in the side. Hawk corkscrews, slams on his face, and slides across the hall completely unconscious. Garion and the Templar rush in rage to defend him. Templar swings, hits. Garion swings his short sword and hits. Two armor saves. One wound. Garion's sword just slices where the Plodron used to be. And slices Silas down. Silas counterattacks, but his earth magic fails as the two are wearing Templar armor. Freya, your turn.
Question, is there anything that me and Niosei can do? Does it, like, if we combined, does it, like...
You have to train to do that.
Oh.
Well, you are siblings. You have grown up together.
Like, do you know, it's
ask him.
Like...
Ask him. Okay. Ask him.
Can Freya run up to Niosei then?
Well, you've got to run past Silas. You're on either side.
Oh, shit. Hmm. Let's walk around him.
Yeah, you can run, it'll cost one action to run around him, yeah.
Okay, yeah, I'll do that.
You like run around the pillar, you know, there's bits of mirror shattered everywhere, you slide across some of the mirror glass, dodging the embers, and Niosei's stand. You just watched Reiner fly over Niosei, and Niosei's just ducked as Reiner's like, ah! Into the wall and slid down it.
Okay,
good. I've got no break.
Yeah, Brace is very like slide into him. It's like, you'll probably know more about this, but if we, like, did an attack together, would it, like, amplify? Like, would it be more...
How does your friend's armor work?
What do you mean?
Well, I'm assuming their armors work similar. They seem to be connected
well,
in some way.
Yeah, I think they're related.
So how does his Voltrum's armor work?
I don't know.
How do you not know? You've been traveling with him for almost 2 years.
I don't know. This is not what
it works on hit. It builds charges.
Ryder just stands up. Yeah. Like this table explodes where Ryder emerges.
Well, of course, Ryder was caught by
Niosei,
right?
No, Ryder was a reject on the edge of town.
No, as in Ryder got caught by Niosei.
Niosei ducked under him, so Ryder slammed into a table.
Oh, right.
And just like stood back up, but they are next to each other. Yeah, Ryder, you can chip in if you want. Go on.
Well, I'd say what I just said.
Yeah, they were... Alright, so we need to be careful how many times we hit him. He's got an unarmored part on his shoulder. Garion's just proved that. We must aim for that. It's going to be harder to hit, but maybe we can chip away at his armor.
Okay.
But if we hit his armor, he's going to be able to summon that sandstorm again. And whatever did this to Voltrum, he, like, flicks Voltrum. He goes, ding!
Okay, so... Is there something we could do? Because I just need two more hits.
Well, we overwhelm him. We'll try it your way.
Okay, so is there something we can do?
I don't know, Freya. A big fucking fireball, maybe? Right, you're an hand-to-hand expert.
Yeah.
Fire kicking, get in there hand to hand, lay some fire punches.
Yeah,
down.
But I'm saying if you also do something.
Yes,
at the same
I
time,
will.
But
oh,
let's just go
Freya.
Together. I swear to God. Fine,
yes,
you go round.
Yes, let's go. Yes.
And then
what,
do
around
it.
To the side you just kept. Meanwhile.
So ask you.
You
did her
a nightmare.
Meanwhile, Xylus, you see Xylus grab the Templar.
No.
Grab his lower jaw and just split the
did
Templar.
Did he not roll for it though?
I just
rolled. He turns to Nereus. He's like, "This is no time for us bickering. Just you go that side, go that side."
Right, and he like, which direction do you go?
Left.
Okay, good, because he yelled right as he departed. You rush down around to the left side of him. You see Nereus fire these three fireballs at Xylus. Xylus is easily but kind of confused at how they miss him, and then. Neose brings them back and all three slam into the back of him, forcing him down onto one knee. Now, Freya!
Okay. Can I...
Fire kick?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, roll... no, we just agreed. Yeah, so go.
Roll your wisdom.
Oh, okay. 19!
You summon this massive fire kick as you fly forwards, rocket propelled, and you strike him straight into his helmet. There's a huge burst of fire behind him as he gets catapulted backwards. Now it's his body corkscrewing across the floor. Injured. Oh, that's too much. Injured, he arises and like summons this massive pillar of earth around you. Roll a dex to see if you can dodge all these spiked bits of wall.
Oh, Jesus. 10.
What's your dex?
Dex is, I think, is 10. I think it's the page. It's 10, yeah.
You manage to jump across the spikes as they appear, and while he's focused on you, Neose fire kicks him from the other side. He does a roundhouse, unlike yours, which is a falcon kick.
Yeah.
He roundhouses and slams into the left temple of his helmet. The Xylus corkscrews and smashes his spine into a pillar. The whole pillar shakes as all this bits of debris and ember fly down. And Neose's like doing your battle stance now in front of him.
My battle stance?
Lulan, your turn. He is now completely parallel to you, back against the pillar.
Okay. Just to remind you, he is in a blood pact with me. Put that out there.
What's blood
pact? Sorry, do I get blood token for that? Not
fire.
Blood token,
a
fire
token.
You get
a fire token,
sorry,
yes.
I'm always talking about blood tokens.
Yeah.
Do I get one?
Yes.
Cool.
It just means that I can mark an enemy with a blood pact and I can instantly kill them once they reach 2 HP at any right. range.
Yeah. Cool.
Just from... okay. He's parallel to me. I'm gonna... Is the unarmored side exposed to me? Is it close to
me?
Well, he's the other side.
You're opposite the hall, directly parallel to him.
Gonna run to him, I suppose.
Yeah.
And try to nick him on the unarmored side.
All right, you're gonna need to roll high dex here because he's a big old boy. You dash. You kind of like dash, right next to Neose, who's.
And this will be a transfusion, melee.
Oh, to heal yourself.
No. It's I can melee and I can suck the blood from the enemy to deal 2 damage and get 2 tokens.
All right, okay, yeah. You want to rush him and do that? You got to land a hell of a good hit with a dex because his shoulder is the only unarmored bit.
Twelve, and my dex is 12.
I'll land to take a. It does hit. Technically, and it's a magic ability, so fine. Yes, you get 2 tokens. You suck like a little bit of blood out of him, but he is going to get to counter attack.
Yeah,
he
great.
Grabs you
that
by
was
the...
only one. Oh, no, it was
no. You ran. He grabs you by the throat and catches you, and begins to crush your windpipe slowly. He lifts you up with one hand, so you're off your feet.
Can I try and kick him?
You haven't got any armor. You can struggle. Yeah, roll a strength.
God. Is that's a 2.
Yeah, You're going to take two wounds as he begins to crush you.
Okay.
But just before you get to do that... no, it is actually his turn. He's going to... This huge wall of earth grabs you like the blood coffin and begins to crush you as he lets his arm go and begins to walk away. You take another wound and you now need to pass the strength test. Voltrim, you miss this turn, but after this your turn, the earth begins to dismantle from you. Rykard disappears, but everyone in the room kind of sees a visage of green just vanish. Cassian's turn. Rushing towards Lulin's aid, Cassian's sword bursts into flame and he fires these two slashes of fire. Silas just puts up his arms like that and blocks both. But as he does that, he's blinded by Cassian's lunge. Cassian lunges and stabs him straight through the shoulder, pinning him against the wall with his longsword. Silas goes into the wall and just disappears into the chamber walls.
Just reminds me of that Homer Simpson meme.
Yeah, he does. He just does that, yeah. Nyose goes on guard. Lysandra goes on guard. Garion standing over the wounded hawk. Miranda and the rifle squad with Leaf have reloaded and they're standing in like a dome shape. So all their rifles aiming at each side of the Great Hall. Meanwhile,
no.
On the other side of town,
I like to listening to their battle. Just keep doing that. Oh shit!
So there are these three guards, heavily armored guards. You're on the very center of the decking of the ship. The three large masts have completely come down. So the sails are ready. And you're standing in the middle as these three guards are kind of like eyeing you up. You've dodged a couple of the hits already. But in the back, behind them, you see one with a spear and he's like trying to stab and impale Nubbins, who's like trapped between a bunch of barrels and a bunch of buckets under the stairs.
Master, help!
Behind you, this like black snake is being stabbed to death by a bunch of the crew with their like bill hooks, and their cutlery equipment, their knives, they're just stabbing at this dead snake. You hear on the other side of the decking is Devlan, and three guards on the upper decking are about to point their rifles at you.
Okay, they're on the upper decking, right?
Those guys, yeah.
Okay, so there's three up there. There's also three in front of me. Yeah. That? So I got six targeting me and one targeting Nubbins.
Yeah.
Okay. I have a plan. Do I have time to do anything? They're like loading or are they just about to shoot?
Well, the musket ones are loading, yeah.
Okay, I'm going to reach into my pocket. I'm going to grab as many Society of Hobgoblin internment therapy badges as I can. Because yeah. I've stashed up on merch. And I'm going to try and deceive everyone and go, Nubbins, get off the boat, this is going to blow big! And throw them at all targets as if it's like, you know, little pellet grenades. And I'm going to like,
charisma. Ah! Actually, it's an intimidation. Roll intimidation.
Okay.
Did you take those badges to a foursome, Tom?
He's always got them in his pocket.
I rolled a 7 and my intimidation's a 6.
All these badges scatter everywhere. A bunch just hit like ping off this winged bat helmet of the guards. And they roll around. Everyone just stops for a split second.
Can I use that second? I'm gonna hop through them.
Hold on. Roll the dex.
I'm running towards Nubbins.
Yeah.
That was a 6, which is not great. But my dex is 11.
You get slashed across the back with the first sword and take the wound. Okay. As the first guy goes, like cuts your back open. Roll a second dex.
18.
You dodge the second sword, the third guy.
Fuck me. Alright. 18.
You dodge the third guy. The muskets.
But now I'm behind them.
Yeah, I don't care. The muskets are still aiming at you.
Can I grab a dude and pull him in front of me?
You want to roll a strength in this?
Oh, jeez. A 13 with a strength of 8.
Yeah, so you grab the guy, the muskets go off, one of the armored guys gets shot like 3 times and slides across your chest as he begins to like gurgle blood.
All right.
The 2 guys behind you, though, now you've stopped. One stabs you straight in the back of the leg.
Surely they're side to me. Because I'm like, they're not behind me, right?
I grabbed. Yeah, they are now, yeah. You grabbed the last guy.
I thought I hopped over. And
no, no, you didn't get the chance to hop over yet. See.
Okay, so I've been slashed. Can I sort of react?
Yeah. That's my reaction.
Well, with my... I do have a move for this, which is... I have a parry, but I don't have a rapier, so she can figure out that.
Yeah, so he stabs you, kind of impaling your leg to the decking. As you go down to one knee, the armored guy falls, the one that you're holding falls, and you watch the musket men rapidly reloading. However,
that took another wound?
Yeah.
Fuck.
However, one of them stands at the top of the stairs in front of you and aims his rifle at you, and suddenly his head goes and explodes like a melon. All this blood and brain matter flies over you. It kind of panics the other guards for a second, and they're looking around. One of the other riflemen spins. Suddenly his head goes poof, and he's back, and he falls over the decking and slams in front of you. Blood spooling out where his lower jaw and brain used to be.
What weapons did these guys have?
They had rifles.
The ones right next to me who were slashing at me are getting there.
Oh, no, they had swords.
And they're still fine. It was the rifle guys who got their heads.
Yeah, 2 of the rifle guys are dead. The other one's looking around, panicking. And you see him rush off to duck behind some cover as someone's sniping from afar.
Okay.
However, this gets the attention of Lady Von Heim. And she's flying in the sky. She flies over and you see her fire all these blackened feathers that are on fire at this mysterious sniper.
Uh-oh.
There's all these explosions as buildings go up, a tower begins to fall, and you see Gerwa rushing behind walls as one of the walls explodes. Gerwa, you lose one of the rifles in the confusion.
Can you roll to hold on?
He's still got his main, the other one.
Okay.
It's just he wouldn't be able to carry both and roll. Gerwa, roll a dexame.
Natural 20.
You easily jump through a tiny window with the rifle into the inn. As all this debris explodes behind you and all these barrels and a warehouse catches on fire. But Lady Von Heim's attention is pulled suddenly as she looks back and she sees that Alexander is being like cut repeatedly by Azrael in this like clawed weapon that he's slashing across Von Heim's chest. Von Heim grabs Azrael, slamming him into the deck and stomps him through the deck and into the water. And the two lovers kind of exchange this look of like, we got this. And suddenly a snake just through the decking, grabbing Alexander and swallowing him whole and slamming back onto the deck. But before long, Devlan, you'll turn around and you'll just see that the snake's innards are racked open. And Alexander like peels himself back out, covered head to toe in snake guts.
Well, that's disgusting.
Devlan, he spots you at this point. He's like, who are you? As he starts walking towards you.
I'm just a kid. I'm just a street urchin.
I don't fucking believe you. Rats. As he like rushes towards you. You see his blackened claws. He's got like a beastie looking face on him. He's angry.
Did the guard have any weapons on him?
Your father, yeah. He's got a little dagger in his belt.
Well, that's all I have as well.
2 daggers.
All right. Yeah. I mean, I'll take the second dagger anyway.
He's rushing towards you. What do you want to do?
Both daggers in my arms. And as he comes towards me, I want to duck and slash at his ankles.
Oh, roll a dex for me.
14.
He's kind of ground pounds, but he just hits your dead father, exploding him into pulp as you roll between his legs and slice both of his legs open. Ah! He like falls to one knee, slamming his knee into the skull of where your father used to be.
Can I turn and then leap both daggers out in front of me?
Like, yep.
Nubbin style.
Nice.
Jam them into his back and hold on for dear life.
Roll a dex.
4.
You just go over his head, and you slam into the ship and fall into the water.
Knives out? Did I catch the knives?
Oh, yeah, actually, yeah. Roll to see if you catch the knives. I'll give you that.
15!
You go, woo-dum, and land. You're onto the ship, like, holding onto the side of it. You notice the anchor's almost completely raised as it goes past you.
No, can I just... If it's raising, can I grab it?
Yeah, yeah, roll a dex, see if you can make that Prince of Persia jump.
15.
You jump. He slices where your legs, your little leggies were, as you get pulled up on the anchor. I'll allow you to flip him off. As you get pulled up the ship. he screams. You seal him... You see his wounds kind of like seal as he stands up, and suddenly Azrael just smashes through the water riding this snake, and they barrel into each other, sliding across the icy deck. All these guardsmen appear, and they just start firing their rifles at Alexandra, hitting her in the wings as she's like being battered around by these rifle bullets. She begins to return fire. Gerwal, you have an advantage here.
Okay.
She's distracted. You've got a clean line of sight.
Highest is a 19.
Oh, so, yeah.
Yeah, that's, I think, want to be getting onto a roof, but if there's like a hatch or something that I can then pop down under when necessary, to, like, pop the hatch, rest on the roof, track her, and then try and aim for anything I'll hit, and then do as much damage as I can before ducking down again.
The bullet rips through her left eye socket and out the back of her skull. You watch as her crumpled body slides to the floor and slams into the decking.
Gerwal is already reloading the next shot. Just ruthlessly efficient.
As she stands.
And Gerwal's now leaving the spot he's in.
oh, shit! The bullet slides out of her eye and hits the decking as it reheals, and she looks around to where the shot came from. Husband!
Out the door.
Guards! Tons of guards are appearing. He lets loose of Azrael for 1 second, and Alexander does this, like, wolf pout, like, pose. So he puts his legs on the deck, kind of hunches over onto his haunches, and just rips himself forwards of his upper body. Like a bullet, he just flies through these six guardsmen, and they just become pulp. They explode into mist as he slides, raking his talons across the concrete on the other side of the dock. All the stones going everywhere. You hear this horrible, like, nails on chalkboards. Six of the other guards are thrown to the side as they drop their rifles and begin to draw their swords. Angel.
Do I see any of this? I think I'm kind of in the middle of just...
Yeah, you can't. All you see is the ship in your way.
People's heads are popping. That guy's still trying to get nubbins, right?
Yeah.
There's still a guy next to me, though.
There's two guys behind you about to stab you in the back.
Okay.
There are the crew that were killing the snake as well. The four of them pull their daggers out and begin to rush towards you.
Okay.
You see in front of you, hold on, what is this right on? No. My apologies, hold on. Is this one? Hold on.
I'm really hoping it's like a happy sounding song that's going to inspire.
Oh my god, why wouldn't this work? The spearman is like about to stab towards Nubbins.
Okay.
You're looking around, you can feel your heart picking up pace. It beats faster and faster. You can feel the hotness of your blood trickle down your split open back. Your right leg is completely embedded. Every time you try and raise, the guard is holding it down with the sword. And you can feel all the muscles in your calves like splitting like a chicken breast that's been cut open. You feel the like visceral feeling of being impaled into the deck.
Okay.
But time begins to slow. These droplets of the rain fall down slower and slower, and your heart picks up faster and faster. You're not sure if you're having a panic attack or something else is happening as these raindrops, you can almost watch them explode and shatter around you like a little missile strike that's going on. You see the guard posing with his spear slower and slower. You see Nubbins backed his little pot belly as he's like backed
he doesn't
up against
that anymore. He's fed as well now.
As he's backed up against the back of the ship. Like you can even turn, look over your shoulder as you see the three crew members and another long sworded knight just about to behead you.
Okay.
And that's where you notice something's in your left hand. A tanto. Oh. And around you sit six more tantos that have appeared from nowhere.
Okay. And my leg's still impaled, right?
Yep, but
I'm gonna
instantly just blink onto one of the tantos.
I'm gonna teleport to the tanto that is closer to Nubbins.
So as you do, you see the guard still impaled in where you used to be, but there is actually a mirror image of you still there.
Okay.
And you see your former self looking up towards where the tanto was, and there are six other tantos all around you again, just moving with you. They kind of float around you in this circle.
I'm going to move up to the one who's stabbing at Nubbins and just like move his spear unexpectedly so that his momentum's hopefully just gonna send him flying off the ship.
Yep. I mean, why not cut him to ribbons?
Because he's gonna fly off the ship, I don't need to care about him.
Right? Well, no, he's just gonna slam into the stairs, the Nubbins.
In which case, I will just slice him down the back.
So you slice completely pierces his armor. You notice that your blade leaves his body before a single drop of blood has specked through his back. And you just go and slice him again and again and again. He's almost disassembling in front of your very eyes, but very slowly. The two guards behind you, you've just seen that your mirror image you left behind is now gone. And he's reacting very in slow motion, wondering how you've left his impalement.
I'm going to... I'm going to walk up to them and then just point their weapons at each other so that they attack another.
Yeah.
Whilst also cutting both of their heads.
Yeah, so you slice both their necks after you turn them. The three guardsmen running towards you. You can also throw these tantos and teleport repeatedly.
What I was thinking. How many tantos? So every time does a tanto disappear?
No. No, yeah,
I just have
them. They just follow you, yeah.
Are they just following me?
Yeah.
Like, floating or...?
Yeah, they're floating around you.
Okay.
Every time you look at one of your... Before you realise that you've caught it in your hand, so it's almost like you're juggling them, but your brain isn't able to keep up with the speed that you're moving.
In that case, I'll just practice three tantos at three separate...
You watch in slow motion as they... pierce their skulls and out the back of their heads as the three of them, they're still running, they don't even know they're dead yet.
I'm just going to look down and go, fuck! Oh my... And I'll pick Nubbins up slowly and put him in my little pocket.
You watch him go... in slow motion.
Okay, I'm going to look up at what the hell's going on in this battlefield. There's no one else on this ship from what I can tell. There's someone on the turret, yeah?
Yes, he's firing these blue lasers at the snakes.
I'm just going to walk up to him and just...
Don't walk, man. Just throw a fucking tanto.
But I want to use the turret.
Oh, yeah. Okay, fine.
I'll slice him.
Yeah. He's still alive. He doesn't know he's dead yet.
Just shove him out of the way. Grab the turret and blast it, or set it to blast.
So I'll say that if you use another weapon, it will cancel.
Okay, it'll stop what I'm doing.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I'll kill the turret guy. I sense that within myself. And then do I need to roll to see what's going on, or can I just tell?
No. So from what you can see before you is that Azriel is rushing Alexander von Heim. The six guards that are alive are just getting back to their feet. And Alexandra von Heim is looking off into walking towards the inn where a shot rang out.
I'm going to target her because she's on her own. I'm going to try and... Can I teleport to her? Do I have to throw
her? Yes. Yeah, you can throw your tanto at her.
Okay, I'm going to throw my tanto at her.
Yep.
It goes all the way?
Yep.
I'll just appear behind her and just slice off her wings.
Lovely, yeah, nice.
And then stab her through the gut. And if I still can, just slice her diagonally and then impale her brain.
Yep.
And I can do this unchallenged. It's just
You're moving too quick.
On the ground, I'm just going to slice her some more.
Okay, she's a bloody pulp. Oh, no, actually, remember, she doesn't know she's dead yet. That's another thing. So you're moving so quick. You can see that her limbs are peeling apart slowly.
Right.
She's not on the floor yet.
Well, then I'm just going to... Hey.
With every second you see this, like, time is speeding up. Speeding up.
I'm going to run as fast as I can. I'm going to teleport, throw the tanto over to the boys.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Go in the middle of them, because he's running at him. And just get both tentos and throw it at both of them simultaneously.
You'll notice that Azrael attempts, he's able to slightly keep up with him, nowhere near enough. The blade goes straight into his chest, and it impales him, and he begins to fall slowly. Alexander gets completely impaled through the chest as he rushes through it. The blade actually goes straight out of his back.
I'm targeting Azrael with everything I've got left to try and slice him directly in half.
Yep, you're cutting, stabbing.
A worm. Fucking worm.
And then, immediately, time returns. Rykar, you'll just see in this moment, like a bunch of things happen. The woman walking towards you, Alexandra von Heim dissembles. Her wings fall down, her back, her legs, everything splits open, and she collapses like a Lego brick building. The guy on the tower just goes, and smashes into the concrete on the side. Everyone on the crew is just vanished. They don't exist anymore. They're cut to ribbons, bloody pulp like Metal Gear Solid Revengeance. Angel, you're standing there, stabbing and stabbing. Your Tanto disappears in this moment, and Azrael's like lying on the floor, coughing up this like black blood everywhere. Nubbins climbs out of your pocket and just and hurls everything up. Everything. And he falls out of your pocket.
My son, can I catch you?
So confused as to what's happened.
Hopefully being in the pocket helped deal with
my brain! It's rattling in my head!
Can I do anything?
He's just super concussed.
Poor baby.
Because every time you teleported, it's like a car crash. And you were going teleporting repeatedly. Alexander von Heim like falls to one knee and slashes at you, just about catching you just for one wound. As his beating heart slowly fades.
Oh. With that bastard. One blur.
You stab him straight through the heart, yeah. He looks towards his wife, and then he struggles back to two legs.
I'm going to grab his face and go, "You weren't even good," and shocking grasp his face.
Roll a wisdom.
No, oh, that would have been cooler if I didn't roll a 5.
It's only vicious mockery with the thing.
He falls backwards. And slams onto the deck as this blood trickles out of his body into the feeding frenzy of snakes below.
I'm turning back to Azrael. Am I able to stand with my energy?
You're extremely exhausted and you've just remembered the wound in your leg. So you fall to one knee.
Yeah,
panting. You're paling as the blood forms on your back. Clever trick there. Angel.
Yeah, I knew what I was doing. Don't mess with me.
I'm impressed. But you targeted the wrong person. There's like more black blood forms on his mouth. And then he points to Alexandra von Heim, who's standing.
Oh, she's just rehealed.
I'm just going to grab a drink. Leave you on that little note for a second.
Alexandra or Alexander?
Dra.
Nah.
Wasn't she the one that you just cut into pieces like Lego?
Yeah, she's just like super healed herself.
Oh.
Oh, great. That's pretty cool, new ult. Slash
that was very cool.
Power. but kind of upsetting that she's like still there. It's like that moment in the anime like... where it's like, ha ha, through the smoke.
You better watching your face as you went through that, like, and I do this, and Alex is like, yep, and you're like, totally unchallenged. Like,
yep. So, Devlin, Devlin, from your point of view, you've just come up, the anchor like stops rising towards the end, and you're, and scamper up it quickly, and as you scamper up, there is just innards everywhere. There are diced people that look like some mad butcher has gone to work. Someone's arms are cut repeatedly to the point where it's like a almost like a string of sausages. The whole deck.
Anybody alive on the deck?
No. Jesus. The whole deck is red and with like a layer of blood. You're slipping around somewhat as you see, and it's all pooling onto the decks below.
Can I turn around? Is there anybody following me still, or am I safe?
No, you're safe.
Can I just like climb up onto the edge of the boat and just start climbing back down again?
Yeah, sure. as you do that, you see that gore. Again down here, the angel standing over Azriel, kneeling over Azriel. Alexander von Heim's dead behind him, but Alexandra stands, and you watch as her wings kind of fuse back to her back. All her body kind of, she almost looks like a patchwork doll as her body reforms.
I can't signal her.
Can I get to her? Is she quite far away?
She's closer to the other side of the dock than where you are. The boat begins to move slowly away from the dock as well.
Fuck, I don't want to be on the boat then, do I? Is there anything still connecting the boat to the dock at all?
No,
completely free.
Yeah.
All right. Are there any ropes around me that I can like grab to, like on the top deck? Is there anything I can cut to like swing down onto the dock with?
Yeah. There's a load of ropes. You can probably do that from one of the sails. To be honest, do a little Pirates of the Caribbean swing.
That works for me. Can I swing all the way through and maybe make it to her that way?
Roll the decks.
Nine. My dex is, I want to say 11? 12.
Yep, you successfully swing, do a little combat roll. You've still got your two daggers as you stride towards her. She's reforming and like you hear her bones clicking and fusing back together.
Alright, can I try and amputate one of those limbs again before it heals up fully?
Roll a dex for your daggers.
17.
You hamstring her. You slice through both of her Achilles tendons as she falls to her knees, and then you literally watch as it just goes and fuses together, letting out this smoke. She turns, "Be gone, child," puts her hand on your head and fires this like black mist at you. You take two wounds as you're catapulted back across the deck, just stopping at the edge where the deck is kind of collapsing into the water. After she black mists you, you have these horrible visions of being torn apart by wild dogs. Oh. And this mist, you're like pulling the mist off your eyes almost, trying to scratch this this mist. She stands. "You killed my husband." As she walks towards you, Angel. "I will take away that girl of yours. I'll peel her flesh back and skin her alive in front of you. How do you have two lightning elements inside of you, boy?" She grabs your hair and wrenches you upwards, able to hold you off your feet. You feel like the strands of your hair popping in your head.
Not in a sexy way.
My beautiful hair. Can I do anything?
You can try, you can struggle.
She's holding my hair, right?
Yeah.
I'm gonna hidden blade my own hair to get out of the grass.
He used a Sakura. Roll a dex.
A three.
She grabs your wrist and snaps it.
Nah! Well, the one with my hidden blade.
Yeah, hidden blade.
In.
She
but
bends
that's got
your
a fucking
she,
blade in it.
She bends your arm all the way back, so you've almost stabbed yourself in your tricep.
Well, that's gonna be a wound.
Your left arm now hangs loosely as she holds you. Gerwad, did you want to fire your shot?
I did. I'm trying to gauge where they are on the docks. Are they just on like the ground by the?
Yeah, right. Yeah. They're nearer the start of the dock where the shipping containers are, or used to be. Called. They were smashed to pieces.
Gerwar is probably just in the street now.
Yeah.
And takes a shot, and I rolled an 18.
So, Angel, as your turn, you see Gerwar standing there with his rifle. There's a click, powder flies, the bullet soars towards her, goes straight for her head, and her eyes roll backwards, and you see them snap back to focus. She raises her other hand and
can
falls.
Can I react?
You can struggle again.
I just want to... I assume it's been long enough that I can, like, create a hologram self to just kamikaze bear hugger and static stunner.
Yeah, I'll allow that. Gerwar's being force pulled by his neck. So
is that not
going to,
like,
across...
prevent that? Because she gets stunned.
And the clone of you grabs her. She's like, what the... And it stuns her. She falls down to one knee, lets go of your hair. Gerwar, you kind of combat roll. Roll a dex to see if you can get back to your feet quick enough for another action.
17.
You land back onto your feet and begin reloading your rifle, I'm guessing.
Yeah. Trying to get back up a bit as well.
As you stand. She's stunned. She begins to shake it off as her wings let loose. The wing bat you to the side, Angel, and you fall on your good wrist, and you manage to get clear of her as she ascends into the sky.
What's Azrael doing? Okay, great.
She ascends into the sky. Bear me one second, eh?
Oh, shit, I know something I should have probably done. Oh, no, I won't do that.
That's right. As she ascends into the sky, her wings stop flapping, but she seems to be able to levitate and float into there.
Is there a building near me or anything?
There's a few destroyed buildings. The six guards are loading their rifles next to you to support you.
Can I, like, just get Nubbins out of my pocket and send him over to a building?
You watch
and
Nubbins...
And mark him at the same time and go, go!
Nubbins is just running in circles.
No, just go to the building.
You watch him.
Can I roll to try and direct? No. Okay, fine. He's dizzy.
He's stumbling around. She summons this grimoire in front of her. Not the grimoire you've all seen, but this new one. Angel, I'm not even sure you'll be paying attention to what she's done. But she starts speaking these incantations. And your wound on your neck explodes into blood as you feel this screaming agony. And from the book rises this chaos seed that begins to spin. And you're like, screaming with your good hands. Azrael's like, you fucking idiot to you. As she begins to mutter these incantations and this black mist begins to shoot out of the grimoire and of the stone.
Okay.
She looks towards you. Relax, child. You think I would sacrifice my last will to be a slave and puppet to a false god? No, I serve a higher power. We have learned how to master this creation of the void. The great maw opens itself to me, and I understand all beings. I will not sever my connection to
my
other kin.
Can I just fucking roll into the water?
The water's eight. You roll, and you slam onto some concrete steps. Just begin to like.
What happened to the water?
You're on the dry dock bit.
No.
I'm just gonna fucking hobble away as far as I can.
Go on, shoot the book.
Go up. Let loose.
I did roll a 15. I haven't rolled lower than a 15 in a long time, so it's coming.
The book gets a hole through it. She kind of just glances at you and turns back. I sacrifice those men for my husband. And you watch as the six guards kind of stand up and put the muskets in their mouths and pull. And all the guards' brains explode everywhere as this blood begins to form into Alexander von Heim. Angel!
Okay.
Come here.
I'm going to go to... Is that Azrael talking?
Yeah.
I'm going to fucking hobble over to him. Did that do any damage to me, that exploding black thing out of my neck, or am I?
No, you're taking no damage, but you're in agony. You're writhing in agony.
Okay. You fuck off, like, snaker!
Look. This snake slides out of his wrist. This little, it's obsidian-looking snake slides out of his wrist. Let it bite you.
Oh, fuck. All right.
Do it or we all die.
I hate you so much. I'm gonna let it bite me.
Your eyes explode into this rhythm. You see sound for a second. You see art, music, everything flies past you. All this information is digested. Your heart begins to beat rapidly and you feel your leg wound and back wound sealing shut. You're instantly transported back to full health.
And you just give all me part this, of snake now.
All this adrenaline explodes into your body, resets every single one of your cooldowns, and you just become alive with the power of this venom. The snake coils itself around your wrist, and it begins to snap your wrist back. And you watch without feeling any pain as your arm snaps back, and it forms like a brace.
Alright.
Angel. He opens his mouth.
And... Right, final words.
Oh. No, he opens his mouth, and from his mouth, his hands wrap around the hilt of a sword, and he begins to pull it out. Now, the one pain you do feel is that your wound pulses with every inch that he pulls of this blade out, and you see that this blade is made from the seeds of chaos.
Crikey.
As he pulls it out, it's got a fanged hilt. The blade, the handle, the like pommel is all broken and twisted. There's barbed wire across the handle as he pulls it out. The black blade itself is missing chunks, but it forms a long sword, a skinny blade. As he pulls it from his mouth, he passes it to you.
I take it.
Alexander von Heim stands. And he lets out this hollowing scream.
I'm ignoring him. Can I, now, I don't even know if I know how I did what... Is it even my turn? Can I act?
Take the blade!
Well, I've got the fucking blade.
Wrap your hand around it, barbed wire wraps itself over your wrist and connects your right arm to the blade. And you feel half of your face immediately, like, stroke. It doesn't move.
Oh, God.
You can't feel the right-hand side of your body... As you watch as your skin darkens, the veins turn to black on the right arm. It bites into you, and for your right eye, you're in a different dimension. Sitting before you in this great monolith of stone is this hooded being. You can't see its face, but there are tiny little hooded beings everywhere, and they're all in prayer looking at you. Its face changes from all the people you've ever met in your life, Clara. Your father, Roderick, you see the old mentor, you see Willow, you see everyone flashing. Its face never stays the same, it's always conforming.
Sever the webs of fate,
he says to you. In a tongue that you don't recognize but can understand. And this being is floating in this giant stone chair. You, without even realizing it, the blade begins to turn towards Von Heim. Who's charging towards you, and then suddenly you see
Alexander.
Yep. All right. Suddenly you see Alexander von Heim, younger, holding a small boy in his arms, pointing it like apple trees.
Oh, shit, I'm full on time traveling, time weaving here.
He's pointing with the little boy and said, "Daddy, what's this? Who's that?" And then the child, the father turns to you. Go inside, boy, now. Who are you? Get off! And he cuts, and he's dead.
What cut? The sword cut it by itself?
Nope. Your reality snapped, and then you're standing across his corpse, the black blade drinking at its blood. Then suddenly, Alexander von Heim is just a craftsman, selling his wares at the store. And you go behind him and rip the sword through his spine, and gut him. Then, Alexander von Heim is a beggar, begging on the streets. You slice him down in an alleyway. Alexander von Heim is a fisherman. You stab him and kick his body into the ocean. Again and again and again, you kill him. You kill him repeatedly. Always he looks the same, and yet everything is different every time you kill him.
How old is he when I'm killing him?
This age.
Okay.
Whatever age that he looks, 40.
Right.
Around 40. But the final one is you see a glimpse. Almost like you'd seen it when you were making love with him. Almost like you'd seen it when... almost like you'd seen it when you impaled his chest. A locket hung around his chest with a little girl on his shoulder in a little dress. And you see him crying over a grave, weeping. And he stands and he says, "I sacrifice myself for my child." And you watch as the Von Heims try and try again to resurrect their dead girl repeatedly, over and over again, until they're pushed or driven by sorrow and madness into falling down a cursed way to bring back their girl. You see a female dwarf, a tall female dwarf, promising them the world. You see them accepting it. And then as you open your left eye, which is crying repeatedly, your left side of the face, your angel side is completely, like, exasperated and exhausted, not just from the fight, but from the realities you've just been. And you're just weeping, but the right side of your face has this wicked grin all the way to your ear and is bolt right staring. And before you, Alexander Von Heim is on his knees. And the blade, the Void Killer, is impaled straight through the locket and through his heart. You hear Alexandra scream, "No!" as you rip the blade out and you watch his soul being sucked into the blade. His face goes grey and he slams face first. "My husband!" she screams as she takes flight.
At me?
No, she just takes flight.
Can I?
"I know your face, Angel."
I've got my powers back, right?
Except your ult, yeah.
Except my ult.
Yeah.
Can I? Can I lightning bird after her?
You raise your right hand, going to lightning bird her, and this black lightning cracks through the sky at her direction. She ducks and weaves it. She tries to get away. You can roll an enhance, so roll 3 wisdoms for me.
Well, the first one was good. 14, 17. We'll take the 17. Unless it was like 3 different shots.
The lightning bolts pierce her wings, but you don't teleport to her. She begins to fly away towards her ship that's left the dock.
Can I shoot the ship?
The ship's out of range. Azriel begins to stand behind you, his wounds slowly healing. "You did good, Angel. You did good."
I'm going to stab him with the Void Sword.
As you go to, he clicks his fingers and the snake bites you again. And you are immediately frozen, paralyzed. "Oh, Angel. I didn't want to have to click my fingers that time. We were almost at a crossing where we could have been friends."
Can I talk?
Yeah.
"It was a spasm."
Angel. We know each other now. I feel like we're good friends at this point.
It wouldn't be me if I didn't try.
Exactly.
What the fuck has happened to me?
It's very hard to explain. The weapon's not quite finished yet. He places his hand and the barbed wire switches to him. And you watch as half of his face goes black. With, like, melting soot and ash as he puts the sword and he unhinges his jaw and seals the sword back inside of his mouth. The barbed wire coiling.
Do I see, like, does my skin change? Does anything?
Yeah. And your right eye, like, water begins to cry out of your right eye.
"Okay, hear me out.
Relax. I'm not going to kill you.
No. This alliance, I'm up for it."
"Oh, I'm not sure. You just tried to kill me again."
"Yeah, but you've proved
You me. Also stab me repeatedly. I'm very injured at this point."
"Well, I feel fine.
Covering your hair."
"We what are you going to do with that? Because I just traveled through a whole bunch of different dimensions. And I.
It is the only way to kill my father. It is not yet complete. I need 3 more Chaos Seeds.
Okay, before you write this off, I take a moment just to get over everything that just happened.
How did you just move?
Oh yeah, sorry. Sorry for coughing in your face. Listen, we have Chaos Seeds. You're clearly very powerful.
You've got 3, but you need 1, I understand.
Is there any way we can use them and then give them to you?
Well, you intend to burn one to follow this puppet's dream of yours. But no, I'll take the 2, but I'm going to take the 2 and leave you here. The drug will wear off shortly, don't worry, in an hour or so.
Just and before you go, thank you.
Your tower is unguarded right now.
Your help?
Oh, well, it's quite all right. Thank you for your help. Because you helped, I won't kill anyone at the tower. How about that?
Well, hold on. I like the sound of that.
Oh, good.
But there can be a way we work together. You don't have to make this a battle between us. You started this attack. I was just defending myself throughout.
Yes, but you very much aimed for me.
I aimed for her first, then that's, him, that's then true. You.
Which, by the way, I'd like to discuss how you can even do what I saw.
Exactly. I'm a very dangerous person when I'm not
frozen. Yeah, you're a lot more dangerous than I realise.
Yeah, in fact, not dangerous enough to eliminate the health.
When that snake wears off, all your wounds come back, by the way, so you might want to speed this conversation up.
I can't move. I'm just hoping my friends arrive soon while we have this chat.
Well, the feast will be ending soon, so I'm sure they'll be here soon enough. Besides, there's the half-orc over there.
Can I look at him?
And the halfling at the end there. You see Devlin rip the black mist off of his face. Garwa's like standing up from choking. And he's loaded his... loaded his rifle.
Like a while ago. If you allow me, he's gone and picked up all 6 of the rifles that the men shot themselves with. Yeah. And he's loaded all of them.
Well, that's right next to where they're standing.
Oh. Yeah, he's pretty close then. So he can hear everything. He's just like loading guns.
Can I try and force myself to move?
As you do, you watch as your arm slowly peels back to being broken.
Can I do it anyway towards him?
Now, Angel. He pats you on the shoulder.
As he does so, can I mark him with physical contact?
Yeah, okay. You mark him.
All right.
Now, Angel. It's been a pleasure, and our paths might cross again. But perhaps it's us killing Lady Vonheim before she kills us. How about that?
Before, explain what she was about to do with the book and
she resurrected her husband. She's been doing it for years.
But the mark out of the back of my neck.
Yeah, she has a Chaos Seed for it. Right. Every time she resurrects her husband, she uses a Chaos Seed. But instead of activating it, she's been trained by another group of enemies. Void, my father, and his little peons of the Chaos Gods aren't your only enemies.
Right.
There is the Cult of Mor as well.
And what about, what did I just go through with that sword? How did I eviscerate him out of every timeline without any self-control? Did you make me do that? Did I do that?
It's the forging of the Void Sword and channeling of an outer god. My father believes himself a deity, but he's not. In truth, there are gods out there.
And who's your father?
Void, the King of Chaos.
The Cult of Mor have been plaguing the Dwarven holds for decades, centuries.
And they are back. The Southern Mountains has fallen.
Yes, of course.
Before you go, is there any way we can create an alliance? I know we started off on the wrong foot, but we clearly want the same thing.
I think next time we meet, if you don't try and kill me, why don't we have a civil discussion? But for now, I have to leave before the guards get here.
But what if I shoot you now?
Then you die.
Looking at Angel?
I wouldn't do it.
Bye, Angel. Bye, halfling.
How long should I expect this to last?
You'll know when it's about to end, because your arm will probably snap back.
Right.
The snake slivers off and onto his arm. Bye for now, as he throws this leather coat back on and walks back into the city. Guards come screaming past him into the chaos and looking around. What happened here? Angel, your arm just goes...
And my leg. Everything just reverts, right?
Yeah, slowly, bit by bit.
Go come and splint your arm using one of the rifles.
Yeah, to snap it back.
Don't do it. I don't... At least like, knock me out or something. Don't break my arm back! Are you going to do it?
Yeah.
I want to struggle.
Your lower body isn't responding yet. It's still numb. Meanwhile, as he slowly walks off into the crowd, he kind of looks back and shoots you like a...
As he
walks off, the crowd forming around you, everyone's like, it's one of the champions! What's happened to the doc? Hey, what's going on? As they begin to swarm you. Why are the guards dead? And there's all these like corpses lying around. Devlan, you've caught up to Gerwar and Angel. Is there anything you'd like to say?
In a bad time.
Why didn't you shoot the cannon? The cannon! The blue cannon on the ship! You fucking jumped off and stabbed her!
Had two knives. I didn't have a hand free for a cannon.
I hate this. I can't move.
I'm sorry, your last instructions to me were to just get out of here safely, so excuse me if I'm not entirely on the ball.
Listen, I've marked him. I could technically teleport him back here and we'll jump him. He didn't realise I did.
Well, you'd swap places with him.
Yeah, but he'd be surrounded by all of you lot, so let's just gather everyone we've got and put me in a circle, and he's not going to see it coming.
Do you want to do it?
Well,
I'm not especially keen on this idea.
I don't think this is a good idea.
It feels like quite a personal vendetta, and I'm not sure I want to fight your battles for you.
I'll be right back. I'll run.
I don't want to come true.
Do it.
No, Alex is like, I want to fuck you up.
No, do it. It'll be fine.
Yeah, we don't have anyone here.
Oh, there's like 100 guards arriving.
No, they can't. We can't take him with guards. He'd turn into 100 snakes. I need the heroes, the champions.
The mark will last a little while anyway.
Yeah, it's in the back of my mind. I'm just verbalizing. I need to go to the Robin's Tower. Guards.
Yep.
There's a man in a trench coat, and he's going to the Robin's Tower.
What's he look like?
He's in a trench coat and he looks like he'd shoot you a wink like a little shit, and he's kind of serpentine-y. And he's got half of his face is a different colour potentially.
What's his skin tone?
Well, did half of his skin change?
Oh, that faded that when he put the sword back. We respond quicker to Nunjuk. No, it's because he's in his snake form, so quite an easy description. I'm just reminding you.
Yeah. He looks serpentine. He's the snakiest person you could probably see.
Right, lads, you
to the Robin's Tower. Don't split. Robin's Tower.
Okay, to the Robin's Tower, Marshal, and a horseman rides. Okay. Guards,
who's actually
to the keep?
Be there?
To the keep. As this knight arrives, in a like winged helmet. The king is dead! Okay, the king is dead! As this horseman arrives at the dock, all the guards like drop what they're doing. To the castle! The castle's on fire! We're under attack! And all the guards sprint towards the main castle.
Oh, fuck.
The knight's there. Sir Angel! The king is dead! Assassins! The castle's on fire! Come on!
I'll be right with you!
The horseman's like, he leaves his horse. I'll get another one. Don't worry, he runs with the guards. Go on, Devlan and Angel. You've just found out the king is dead.
Yeah, that's not a good night.
Bells are tolling across the city. The only king of Midland, Victor Trost, your king, as the guy runs off.
Yeah.
As long as it's not the king of the dwarves. I like that guy.
Right, I'll give you guys a little moment to ponder. Back in the castle. So, Voltrim, you're like shaking off the rubble. There's so much like almost sleep in your eyes. He appears from another a pillar and just wails on Niose from one side. Niose kind of grabs his wrist and goes to throw him, but goes flying instead from the punch. Cassian slices and brings his sword straight into the armor chest. And the sword, you watch as the armor almost snaps down like teeth, catching the blade, and then he punches Cassian in the throat. Your father's like, oh, and goes down to one knee as he Spartan kicks your father in the face, breaking his nose and sending him flying. How many turns?
How many turns this session has there been?
Two. Why?
Okay, one off a cooldown.
Cool. Ryan, are we open with you?
Can I do anything to save the king? My king, the Elven king.
Cassian, he's not a king, but yeah, he's sliding across the floor with his broken nose. Lysandra's rushing with you.
Ooh.
She rushes. Lysandra rushes to your side. Reiner, give me a wind blast in his direction. I've got an idea.
Okay, I'll use wind surfing. The boss push.
Yeah, as you do, she summons like a giant fireball, and you watch the wind just expand the fireball rapidly. It begins to fill the hall. Oh, fuck, she says. As she does.
That's right, I've already burnt it.
She underestimated your power. You see,
Ryan rolled a natural 20.
Oh, okay, that explains it. This giant fireball explodes through one column, explodes through the second column. He turns and summons a huge wall of earth that expands, even protecting Freya by accident, as this giant orange fireball smashes into it. Bits of rubble, burning rubble, and debris go flying everywhere, and his bit of wall just crumples, 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 crumples down until it's just protecting him. Freya, this fire blast is going to do one wound to you and send you flying backwards. Lulun, you're encased in stone.
That's good.
Question, should it?
Yeah, it's a volatile fire.
Does it apply a stack of her fire?
Yeah.
To Freya?
No, does it apply to Freya's fire to him?
No, sorry. But, Lulun, the rocks you're in now begin to heat. You're basically in an iron coffin being burnt alive. So you take two wounds. Freya, you take a wound. Xylus is...
Lovely, guys.
But it's very effective and a great reminder that you guys could do this at any point. Reiner, you've got one more turn.
I have no idea what I do these. Give me 2 seconds.
Okay, well, as you're doing that, Lysandra jumps and cuts his stone wall away and sends all this rubble and debris into his eyes. As she swings at him again, he manages to just parry, like, pirouette out of it, and she's pressing him hard with her axe, swinging it wildly, forcing him backwards as the muskets are tracing him. Leaf's like, hold your fire, wait! As he's being pushed into the main center of the square.
Okay, so yeah, as she's doing that, I want to try and get behind and place a wind trap on the floor.
All right, roll a wisdom.
12.
He steps back, activating a wind trap, right, realizing, and flips into the air, suspended in the air. His turn, he's going to struggle, he fails, struggle. He shoots out his hands either side to try and get balance as the earth begins to form almost around him.
I do believe I get a free attack on him.
You get a free ranged shot, but you haven't got a ranged weapon.
Yeah, so Ty picks like up and chuck it at him.
Yeah, okay, I'll allow that. Roll a perception to see if you...
Can I pick up like a little... Okay.
Well, roll a perception, I'll tell you what you want.
Rolls a 12.
A long sword.
10 to hit.
You got a long sword, Ryan, do you want to throw that? Max?
He did say connection is bad.
Max... throws the long sword, it shoots across and just impales Xylus straight through the shoulder and out the side, scraping along his helmet. his left hand kind of becomes unusable at this point, and the rock formation around him breaks from that side. Freya, your turn.
Okay, is he surrounded by stone, or is he like...
He's trying to pull stone up to him so that he can pull himself out of Reiner's wind trap.
Nice. Okay. Have I got two actions?
Yeah.
Okay. Can I do... Wait a minute. I'm just reading. Okay, can I do Feather Flame?
What's that one?
Can I... So it's the little fireballs.
Yeah, yeah, five little fireballs.
But each fireball, you saw fireball, gives me a token.
Yeah, if I wrote that, then that's what it does.
Yeah. So then, so can I do the feather thing?
Yeah, roll, oh, you're high AERs. Yeah, roll five wisdoms for me. See how many hit.
Five, okay, jeez. Okay, 13.
Hit.
20.
That's a hit.
14.
That's probably a hit, yep. I don't know what your wisdom is, but I'm almost certain.
19. God, these are good rolls.
Popping off.
I know. It's my Tsukino Gojo stickers.
14.
All five fireballs hit. They smash into him, and you watch the wind tornado just burst into blue flame as he's caught in a vortex of blue fire. Everyone's kind of having to shield their eyes as the fire picks up. The whole of the Great Hall is now ablaze as three fire mages are clearly a nightmare in a small confined space. You're all beginning to choke slowly as well, by the way, as smoke fills the air. He is, yep, smash of a bunch of fire blasts.
So, I've got another action though, don't I?
Yep.
Right, I'm at six tokens. Can I detonate him?
Freya does this like standing pose and then clicks her fingers and this huge fire explosion of blue flames explodes where Xylas was, and bits of burning armor fly across the room, landing all around the place. You watch some of the guards get kind of knocked back by it, and this charred, half-charred man lands to the floor. His shirt is off. You see that he's fucking jacked. He's basically just Toji at this point, and he's completely just burned from one side of his face. He's missing half his hair. All this like flesh is bubbling and blistering, and some of it is like charred ash, just almost like burnt bacon. This mouth-watering smell of cooked pork fills the room, and some of you that maybe didn't eat your fully finished your dinner, you maybe your mouth waters. He's like standing, coughing up this boiling blood. He like mutters a word under his breath. None of you can quite hear it as this earth mouth swallows him whole and pulls him under.
No. Oh.
But
remember, he's marked as well.
Yeah, two plodrons and a fembrace or brace lie on the floor. So three out of the six pieces of armor are burning. And around you.
Fuck.
Would you have
allowed me to have done something then?
What would you want to do?
I would have, like, I am the shielded and then summon the axe through him.
Who would you have the shielded? He wasn't near anyone.
Just to him.
I think it's the only allies.
Oh. Yeah, but... true. He's not an ally. But even then, it was still on cooldown.
All these guards rush in through the now open doors and begin throwing pails of water everywhere. You're all covered in soot and smoke. Leave the hall, please! As all these guards are coming in, water mages come in and begin like firing water up against. You see Ares Oakheart leading them. We'll put the fire out! There's another fire at the dock! There's fighting at the dock! Someone's attacking us! Ares says as he rushes to you all. The stone coffin breaks, by the way. Lulan, you're burnt all over, but you roll out. Lysandra's like, sorry. As she pats you on the back. Oh, sorry. Mm. Aloe vera.
Thanks.
There's a fight in the dark as all these guards come and rushing back.
There's like two separate sets of guards. Like, the kings are dead in the castle. There's a fight in the dogs.
There's all this chaos. Henry kind of like stands up and washes the smoke out of his eyes as Rob rushes to him and helps him back up and dusts him off. And they exchange like words and kind of hug. Roll a perception, all of you.
Reiner rolls a 19, Vulture rolls a 3.
Frey rolls 12.
17.
Reiner, you see Rob give Henry Cassandra's pistol, and he puts it up in a bag. Henry like dusts himself off and he looks towards you guys and kind of just nods curtly. Efforts to he starts yelling out commands. Put the over there, water mages, the hall. We must protect what we can. We cannot let the castle fall while an invasion is here. And he immediately snaps the command and people begin responding and following around. Each sheaths his longsword and then walks out towards the courtyard as all these nobles begin to gather, and his red-headed girlfriend, bear me 1 second, apologies, Lady Jenna strides forward with a bunch of the Midland nobles. The king is dead and an invasion is coming. We must look to new leadership. She stands on the lower step.
Okay, I'll give it a moment.
This is really fucking quick.
And the head priest there and all the manor lords and merchant lords are like, agreed, an invasion is happening right now. There's a fight at the docks.
Wait a damn second. Whoa. Wait, that's just, what the hell? This is really quick.
There's a fight
also,
at the docks.
Has Will?
Yeah, wait, Angel. Yeah. Oh, I mean, it's right. I feel,
Henry
like this
turns
is way
to you.
Quick.
Don your armor, champions. An invasion has begun. The docks are aflame. Prepare yourselves. The enemy is upon us. Rob's like putting his armor on next to you with Trevor.
Can I kind of look at Rykar and be like,
"Yeah, Rykar's probably by Trost's body."
No, his body was carried out long ago.
Long ago? Okay.
Yeah, you guys pushed Silas from that hall and into the Great Hall.
Oh, yes, of course.
Can I go help Hawk up? Because I'm assuming he's still unconscious.
Yeah, yeah, he's commanding the mages as well. But he's gathering around. I haven't got my battle armor. Lulin, pleasure to finally meet you properly. Apologies for not getting the chance earlier. I can't believe the king is dead, but we're under attack already. The guards are screaming something about the docks.
Yeah. Don't know if that's more pressing than what has happened in this hall. I think when panic sets in, people say things. So I think you got to be a leader right now and use your gut instinct, not what other people are saying. You're a head mage for a reason. Use your gut.
Battle mages, put out this fire. The rest of you follow me to the dockside. We'll see what's going on over there. Oh, God, that was a big dog bunk. We'll see what's going on over there. And, like, he rushes out the hall with some of the battle mage. Ares remains with the water mages. Henry begins, like, yelling out commands. Sorry. Hello?
Can I confront Rob about the pistol?
Yep, you can try.
Do you want to tell
Rob,
someone?
Rob, I haven't got an earpiece. I'm not near any of you. Why did you give Cassandra's pistol to Henry?
He puts his metal, like, armored hand on your shoulder. You didn't see that. Rob's staring at you very seriously.
Rob, if there's anybody you can trust, it's me.
Greater machinations are at work, friend.
You need to tell me now.
You were right about what is under the Church of Solace.
But how does Cassandra play into this?
I'll explain if we survive this battle. And he cups your head. I promise you this.
Rob's getting going.
Yep.
Well, the bells are ringing for this invasion at the docks as all the Antian nobles and merchant lords are panicking. Henry's standing now with a breastplate on, yelling out commands as riflemen and bowmen take the keep and begin to go to protect the city. Meanwhile,
can I step outside and fire another firework? Actually, outside this time.
Yeah, Angel, you see this firework going off in the distance. I'm confused about what it is. Your leg's bleeding, but you're standing there with Devlan and Gerwa.
All right, guys. Can I move, or am I still paralyzed?
Yeah, you can move.
Okay, I'm going to crumple down and go. Listen, I know he's a very strong person, but he's heading towards the Robin's Tower right now and going for the chaos seed that's there. We can't let him just do that. I am going to teleport so that he comes back here. I'm thinking maybe you put something heavy on me. I'm going to try and time this to be like just when he... if we go somewhere and he just goes away. Is there any way away from... Is there a ship? Is there a little boat?
There's loads of ships,
Put me on the boat! Put me on the boat!
Two are on fire.
The one that isn't on fire. I'm gonna... I don't know if these guys are helping me. I'm gonna talk to those guards and ask them to put me on a boat.
Yeah. I mean, they help you on the boat. Devlan and
Set, Set me off!
Are you sure about this? They say as they put the sails. It's a small fishing dinghy. And they begin to move you to the swells.
I've never been more sure about anything in my life.
The guards kind of nervously look at each other as if there's a reputation about Angel.
Now, keep in mind that very soon on this boat, there's going to be a horrific enemy that you cannot take. Hopefully, he's just going to take the hint and fuck off. But if he tries to attack, just don't fight him.
The guards look at Gerwa.
Don't fight him.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Push. Push hard.
As the boat... drifts off and towards the swells, yeah.
As it bobs away just enough that I think it's like gonna be enough to piss him off and deter him, I'm gonna swap places.
You swap places. You appear in the Tower of the Robins.
Mm-hmm. So he's made it to the tower.
Your Tanto is embedded into the table, and there is a fresh flagon of ale poured for you and some food.
He's got there in that much time.
There's a little note. As well on the Tanto.
Thanks for the escape.
Well, can I just swap with him again?
No, you can't.
How come?
The mark only activates once.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Right.
But from Devlan and Gerwa, your perspective, you just see a stone statue appear. And it's on the boat as it drifts off. And you kind of look at each other. And the guards look at you, it's like, that's just a stone statue.
And it's...
what does it look like? I mean, I'm not there. But...
well, it's just a stone version of Azrael.
I think our friend was outwitted by this one.
I'm not sure that went quite how he expected it to.
No.
Back at the Tower of the Robins.
I'm gonna...
Devlan, sorry. You're going back.
What was the note, sir?
You pull your Tanto out.
Mm-hmm. My Tanto...
Yep,
because that was in one of his statues.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And you open the note and it says, I owe you 2 chaos seeds. Love, Azrael. P.S. Dinner's on me.
2 kisses.
Oh. I'm going to look around. Is Bernie alive? Is Bernie...
yeah, Bernie's like, are you coming too? Master, I've tried to stop him. Something... bit me on the old neck here. Does it look bad? There's just like 2 puncture wounds.
He did promise not to kill, so hopefully I'll look at it.
Yeah, it looks fine.
Can I just do a quick observation to make sure he's not like... because I tell... well, I don't know anything that happened actually, so I'm just going to look around. A 9. There's no sneaky Azraels.
No sneaky Azraels, but you remember that Clara was supposed to be running this way.
Alright. I guess I'll just burn it. Take me downstairs.
You hear dripping.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Well, I'll head towards it.
There's like a splat, 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 and your heart begins to sink into your chest. And you open the big iron heavy door and push it open. And it's just a rotting tap.
You're a dick.
You're such a dick.
Fucking hell.
There are Knights of the Silver Tree rush in. They're like, the docks are under attack. Oh, Sir Angel. How are you here?
We need to work on your time.
Clara's in the Silver Fort. The rest of the men are up in arms. So there's only 300 of us here, but we're repairing a defense at the docks. Everyone else is at the keep. Clara like opens the doors. Angel, how did you get here?
It doesn't matter. I'm just
what your wounds. She like rushes to you. Heavy bosoms just hanging in the lingerie that she's in.
Yes. I think at this point I'm just gonna crumple to the ground because it seems like it's all over and the adrenaline's wearing off and I've got a broken, splintered arm, stabbed leg, slashed back, and bleeding everywhere.
You see one of the guards, two of the guards is helping Trevor cross dimensions. Casanova's being held up and he like lifts his weary head up and he's like, "Thank you so much for saving me, Angel."
You're welcome. We killed Alexander, but Alexandra got away.
He always comes back. I've tried so many times.
Not this time.
Oh.
How about we save that for the morning?
The medics begin to swarm you. Back at the keep.
I'm just going to peace out and go unconscious.
I missed an opportunity to do it earlier, Alex, but I think Voltron would take control of the dwarfs themselves.
Yeah.
And basically just like shouting at all the nobles, saying, take control of your houses, mm-hmm. take control of your clans. Do not listen to commands for others. Protect the city, make it safe, and wait until further orders come. We need to be on guard now.
The Knight of Stalwart Shields passes into dawn. And no invasion comes, no sight of enemy ships, just one lonely fishing ship sailing off into the distance with a statue on it, but no ships. Everyone mans the defences and is now fatigued and exhausted. They're all in mourning of their king, but no enemy invasion, just confusion.
Can I find Rob?
Huh?
Can I find Rob?
Yes. But we'll leave it there for tonight.
Can I do one thing before I forget?
Yep.
Can I wake up enough and go to Bernie and be like, how did you get that on your face? Gesture towards his mark.
You burned me with a torch.
Ah, Bernie. Go unconscious. Confident that it's not as real in Bernie's skin.
And that was the great feast.
Boo! Why? Sorry, I'm just lashing out. It was very cool.
Oh, God.
What he said.
Beep, boop, beep, boop.
No, that was incredible.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
I got so injured that, like, my health bar has a hole in it.
How was everyone's favourite parts? You're so quiet.
Because we lost.
It's the first mission back. This is what happens.
We uncategorically failed pretty much everywhere.
Yeah.
I don't know. Angel pretty much killed one of the enemies.
Yeah, Frey's awesome this session. I'm well proud of that.
Yeah, finally some combos. Chef's kiss, blood coffin into fireball, into lightning axe.
Yeah, that was sick.
I just first time using the 5-minute conversation about doing a combo.
You took Silas down to 5 health, by the way.
Green Maw and I would have been able to kill him.
Yeah. I was just off, everything was off cooldown for me.
What? Even after I detonated, it was 5 health. Yeah. Oh.
You have to remember you're basically fighting Voltrum.
Yeah, true.
Bigger
Voltrum with Angel's training, yeah. You're a love child of Voltrum and Angel.
But he only has 3 pieces of the armor now. Yep. So.
And you've got 3 new pieces.
So much communication needs to happen.
Mm.
Oh, that hadn't even crossed my mind yet.
I mean, you're going to have to talk to the beast that you...
Yeah. That'll be a series of dice rolls for later.
Mm-hmm. But either you can mix and match, or someone can suddenly get some more earth elemental powers, or some new earth elemental powers.
Looking at Dan.
Oh yeah, the armor will shrink to your size. Don't worry. It's kind of like the one. It's kind of like the One Ring. Otherwise, it'd just be two giant plodrons.
You can't put a sneaky scout in like heavy armor. That is also true.
I was waiting at any point for you to use your earth magic because you could have just pushed any of them through the docks and they would have just fallen into the water. Because your suffocate one where you force them down to the necks.
I assumed that it was like wooden docks, but
yeah, but I'll allow like earth magic to work anywhere, basically.
Oh right, okay.
So they were just gone like Jumanji style and fallen through. I found this song earlier, and I was like, this is like the perfect ending song for like a credit roll.
It feels like a Infinity War ending where you sort of lead the cinema like, oh, we didn't win.
You didn't necessarily lose.
Well, we lost a Chaos Seed. The King's dead.
2 Chaos Seeds. The King is dead.
Yeah.
The King is dead.
We also no longer trust the other King.
Yeah.
What? Henry? Henry's great.
Yeah, I'm getting vibes. Real bad vibes.
You crowned Henry. You're his knight.
No, yeah, but like the fact that it was like... Quick, we need to make him king now. It was like, wait a second.
They didn't make him king. They just looked to him for a command.
No, they tried. No.
He took control.
Oh, well, yeah, sorry. He took control because they were confused.
You've already done it. We've caught on to you.
Funny enough, the only person here that knows is Reiner. So none of you are allowed to have feelings.
No, it doesn't matter because...
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Because he came in and started clicking his finger. No,
he didn't click his fingers.
It.
No, but if
we
you want to speak,
it.
Hold
no,
on.
We've caught on too quickly.
No,
he's
Cannon.
Like it. We've caught on too quickly. You don't like it. No.
No.
Even without the gun.
Cannon wise.
Even without the gun, it still was fishy.
Cannon wise.
Did you mute her?
Yeah, I muted her. Cannon wise, you wouldn't know. So it wouldn't have been that fishy because you all thought you were under attack from an invasion. So you would have assumed that he was just acting in defense. The only person who can be remotely suspicious is Reiner.
And you know the really funny thing?
I'm muted.
Canon wise, Reiner is the least suspicious of him.
So
sorry guys, you're not finding out that info until I talk to Rob.
Yeah, remember none of you are allowed to be suspicious of that.
That's not true. That's not fair.
But we all remember that we've got the will.
You could note that he was like they were pushing for a very quick successor.
That's the thing. It's not even the guy I'm talking about.
No one mentioned successor. No one. Oh God! I wish I could do this in real life.
I'm actively getting my second favorite moment of the night.
Laura's raging is. Good.
Laura just gets off of the bed and walks out.
So. No, I'm joking. I'm still doing that now.
She doesn't want me going into the next room.
I didn't mean to say that they were mentioning a successor. It was more like they thought they were under attack. The idea was that the confusion between both sides, because you're on two opposite sides of a giant city, so all they've seen is like a bunch of fireworks explode on the dock and assume there's some sort of amphibious invasion. But at the same time, all the guards near Tom saw the castle on the hill.
You're wasting your breath, Bob. It's like,
fine.
No, because I messaged Adam before the gun thing happened. I was like, this is fishy. And Adam said the same thing. And then the gun bit happened. So, no.
What part was fishy before?
When the fact they came rushing in,
that was after the gun bit.
No, because they came rushing in before, he was kicking his fingers, and then Rob did the gun thing.
We were talking about how we could have stopped Silas leaving.
Mm.
Like, that's what we were typing to each other.
Mm.
Then immediately after, something's not right, don't like this.
He keeps muting me because he knows that
you're
Bob's. No, before that.
Anyway, you've got the will.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, you've got the will.
Good thing I didn't roll into the water.
I know.
If I have the will.
yeah. It's just covered in blood now.
Bobby, what was
maybe
the will?
We just...
Fine, I'll just suck it out.
Someone else is successor.
On the will.
Maybe a cousin of mine.
Henry of
mine. Say again, Adam?
On the will, Trost is naming Henry as successor.
Mm-hmm.
A little bit of forgery should solve that. Old angels rising.
You're meant to like Henry.
I'm joking.
He's a fucking... You're the good guy.
I'm joking.
He's joking.
Don't mute me.
Please don't. Right, what was your guys' favourite parts of the episode?
I mean, mine's easy. Fucking unlocking super speed was incredible. That one was awesome just because it was like... suddenly ultra powerful, but then the flip side, the complete non-powerful but also destroying Alexander through none of my own will, just like bite this thing. Doctor Strange, a million realities, come back. Okay, I'll take... Did you think I was gonna stab him with the sword? You stopped that real quick.
What, Azrael?
Yeah,
I knew you would. That's why I gave you the snake earlier.
All right.
Not just to heal you, but also I was like, I know he's going to swing. So Asriel's going to know anyway. But so that sword is Void Killer, and it's what Asriel's trying to build, why he sold Reiner to Richard, whatever his name was, for the Chaos Seed, because it requires whatever.
Wait, he sold me?
Well, he captured you, didn't he?
He was Garion at one point. And then he was secretly Asriel.
Hmm.
So he has one left that he needs
to finish the blade.
And we've
kill
got
a
one
god.
Left ourselves.
Yeah, but he says he's not after that one because he knows you need it. Good guy, Asriel.
That's nice of him. To be fair,
he knows we need it for our silly quest or something.
Yeah, silly little quest.
I feel like he's treating us as like an offhand. Well, I mean, if that pays off, that'd be cool. But what else? I don't think it will.
Yeah, he's I guess chaotic good, right?
He's got his own objective. He's tried to help in his own way so many times, and angels are like, Uno reverse.
You betrayed me once. Once was all it took.
How about I just stab you in the face? How low was Asriel, actually?
I'm not going to tell you that.
Oh, go on.
Come on.
Go on. What if I roll really high?
If you roll a 20, I'll tell you.
Just keep rolling. He didn't 13. Say when.
That's true.
Poor Nubbins getting teleported that much.
No, neither of us rolled.
poor.
That was like the box times infinity, but he's leveled up, thank God.
So you can, within that, like your second ult, six of your father's Tantos appear, all infused of his red lightning. So red lightning is unique to only you and your father, which is effectively super speed. I mean, you fought him, and it took all of you to even... pin a weakened version of your father down and mental dying to finish him off. But every time you throw the Tanto, effectively you blink towards it. So you blinking is what leaves a mirror image of you behind,
right?
Which is like why they look like, if you kept throwing it, every time it would pierce anyone, but there could be millions of you on screen at once kind of style, by you just throwing it loads.
Is it like a time limit, or do I just figure this out over time?
You'll have to practice it a couple of times, but it is like a one turn thing. Okay. And it's in a small AoE.
Okay. Well, that was my favourite part.
Dan, what was your favourite part then?
I really enjoyed watching Tom's face as he went through learning about his ult. Just realizing, like, gradually how powerful it was great.
I quite liked your flip off as well, as you hold on to the anchor. Like,
that was a lot of fun. It was nice for Davlan not to be the butt of the joke for a change.
It was. I mean, you hamstring two of the Vonheims without using any magic.
Just got two little daggers.
Lauren,
I'm keeping that other dagger, by the way.
Yeah, you should do. It's a Vonheim dagger. It's beautiful. Except it's got a big fat V.
Guys, by the way, I'm gonna head.
Yeah, no worries, man. Thanks for being able to join, though.
Thanks for joining, Nex.
I'm sorry, even if it was dodgy as hell. I will catch you guys soon. Love you, bye.
Bye.
See you later. Bye-bye. Yeah, Lauren, what was your favourite part then?
Freya and Neosis bickering, but then actually teaming up. That was really good.
Yeah, that was sick.
And then Freya with her fireballs and a detonate. That was sick.
Neosis doing the exact same fighting stance.
Yeah, that was... I've noted that.
That Freya's first detonation as well.
Yeah.
No, you've used it.
I've used it.
Mortarion.
Yeah, but I don't use it a lot.
No, you've only used it twice, Mortarion.
Yeah, which, because I keep forgetting about it.
Yeah. Super powerful.
Yeah, that's what I mean. So I'm going to... Oh, it's there, so...
Chess, your favourite part. Sorry.
Would definitely be probably Angel's new ult.
Cool.
That whole thing, I was just like, holy fuck. That was probably my favourite.
Oh, I just remembered the almost scaring you with Clara.
That was just mean.
What would you have done if it had been Clara?
I mean, half of this episode I felt like I was walking around where I couldn't do anything, and then I could suddenly do anything. It was all or nothing. I mean, what could I do? Just be absolutely devastated.
Cry.
And try and get revenge. But thankfully, it was just Bernie left the tap on.
Well, he'd just been knocked out while doing the dishes. Oh, this isn't a sponge. Adam, your favourite part?
I really liked how the dice supported your narrative with I think Reiner's wind push and a fire.
That worked out perfectly. And something that I've been trying to hint towards Freya and Reiner to do for a year and a bit our time, and in-game a year their time. Because at one point in Season 1, or something like that, you guys did it. You've done it through Windwall, and I said, the Windwall gets set on fire, and now all the arrows going through
this
the Windwall,
like,
flaming arrows. And you were like... You and Max were like, we could do
it. Well, this is what I mean. I feel like we should, you know, when we get to a training situation.
Next episode.
That's what I mean. We can figure out all these combos and maybe actually write them down.
Also, how I like to imagine...
Technique 4. And we all know what that means.
Yeah, exactly. As Asriel puts on his trench coat, I like to imagine he swings it around in that in slow motion.
I hate that guy.
That's how I put on my lab coat when I go into the lab.
Damn, that's cool, man. So I put on my video camera as I go into the camera.
I just struggle.
Just smashed
one
it.
Arm at a time.
And you fall over.
Like, there was also a bit of a highlight when I was messaging Tom.
Yeah, what was that little giggle about I saw earlier?
He broke me. So,
I looked for some memes, but there wasn't any.
Tom said, standing desk is bad luck. To which I responded, no, my ult saved everyone. Followed by, Tom saying, you didn't save that Templar, did you? As the Templar is then just eviscerated by Silent.
Yeah, that's true.
Proceeds to say, you can tell his wife that you all saved everyone.
By him.
Just reminding Adam that, you know, Templars are families too. I need to maintain my NPC.
Well, do you remember when Scribbles was a character and he accidentally fired Resurrection at a Templar?
Scribbles.
And it got locked in the Templar's armor. The Resurrection spell kept bouncing around, so there was just an undead Templar following him forever. It never timed out. The armor kept...
Isn't he guarding a statue still?
No, he was eaten by the Basilisk.
Oh, yeah.
He died fighting the Basilisk. Again.
We forget.
Because the Basilisk pierced the armor and the spell went out.
Scribbles got kidnapped What's like the canon reason for him gone?
He went into the Lazarus pit and vanished.
Oh, and do we know?
Yeah, well, he was taken.
Didn't we get some note like, "Help! I've been kidnapped again."
No, no, Timmy. Well, you saw Timmy, and he told you that dwarfs kidnapped him.
Okay. Shribbles are better off without him.
Cottermore.
Yes.
I was just going to ask, what happened to the guy, the one with the band, Scribble's mentor, and guy? Where did they go?
Saren. Saren just left because he doesn't.
Because they were waiting for someone, weren't they? That was the whole thing. They were waiting.
Yeah,
there.
They were investigating the Church of Solace.
Mm.
And what about Elias, the albino?
Yeah, he's the guy who's investigating the Church of Solace. They were waiting for each other.
They're still there.
They're both investigating.
They went and had dinner and then they left. Elias isn't a fighter. They'll be in the castle somewhere. Elias isn't a fighter. He's a spy. And Saren doesn't give a shit about humans, so he just walked out. Also, he's covered in bandages, so he was just burned alive.
The whole place was on fire, to be fair. As you said, three mages. None of them asked how big the room was. They all just said, "I'll cast fireball."
Yeah. Lysandra being like, "Oh," as the giant fireball just took out column after column after column.
Yeah, I need to do some training with her.
Yeah, training episode, next episode.
We need to not forget that woman who works for the Von Heims who played cards.
Yep.
Because we searched for her and we went to the Room of Memory Loss and we just haven't heard of her again.
Well, she fell off the wall dead, remember?
That was the same person?
Yeah, yep. Missandra, yeah. Miranda shot her in the gut.
She was the woman who we met at the gun competition.
Yep.
Fuck, I missed that.
That's why she had orange hair and orange eyes. I mean, she was in disguise when you bumped into her in the toilets.
Yeah. This is the same one who said death is
in your future.
We also
need to remember to get Gowar to make us some new...
Say again, Tom?
She's the same person who we met and she had tarot cards and she said death's in your future.
Yep.
Oh. I missed that completely.
Can everyone remember their tarot card readings?
I'll have to go back and watch that again.
So... They were spoilers, but I have forgotten them.
I thought both my characters were going to die today. So
you would have, Gowar would have died had he shot Azrael
with all six guns.
don't shoot him.
I like it. You're like, should I shoot him? And you've got his gun to his head and you're like, mm-mm. Just still unable to move.
I was on 3 health, by the way. That's what I finished on.
Oh, wow. Shit, man.
Could have been worse. If that thing that blew up on my neck had, done damage, then I was worried.
But didn't. Yeah.
Do I level up?
That was just all...
You will all level up from this, yeah.
Oh, nice.
Sweet.
Dan, level up.
Nice.
Should I level up?
Oh, I guess, actually, the people in the Great Hall probably shouldn't level up. No, I'm joking. You can level up.
Yeah, they let the king die.
If we failed the mission.
Well, to be fair, if you all hadn't taken a big huff at the room one by one, the king probably would still be alive.
I probably put that evil on me.
you can't put that evil on me!
Maybe if our reactive people hadn't all done what they did.
Well, Freya had her back turned because drunk Reiner took her away. You almost protected him.
Actually. Yeah, I rolled really low.
Yeah. I forgot about that. And then Lulin was stunned, but Angel was also miles away and would have been stunned regardless, as much if not slightly less than Reiner. Because Angel huffed the room
three times.
Nubbins is just concussed to fuck right now. He's been in
go to the building, runs in a circle.
Just face plants. He's basically been in 16 car crashes. Every time you teleport, his brain rattled from one side of his skull to the other.
The emotional arc of Act 4 is going to be watching Nubbins learn how to walk again.
In a little crutch, it's like Timmy from or Jimmy from South Park.
Nubbins.
I just imagine the boy from like the Christmas movie where he's like in the
little Timmy from Christmas Carol.
Nubbins,
as he's like drooling out one side.
To walk and talk again by the end of this.
But yeah, you got a little blue crystal as well.
Nothing of him. He'll be fine.
From
whiplash, it's only if you're like you have mass.
He can only count to three anyway, so.
Yeah. Oh, and Angel threw his badges at everybody, didn't he?
Yeah, I'm gonna have to reorder. They're all on the boat.
The ghost ship that's floating towards chaos.
Do all these badges pop up? Then spread out throughout the world.
The what chaos like, propaganda is this?
The chaos Vikings are like boarding it because obviously she's just going to fly home, and they're like, "What is this?" And now you're just going to see a bunch of chaos soldiers invading with shit badges on their chest.
I really thought that was going to work out better than it did.
Yeah,
if she's flying off, does that mean her ship's left?
Say again, Chess.
If she's flying off, does that mean her ship has left?
Yeah, ship went out to sea.
Oh, what, with Azrael?
No, with no one. It was dead.
So,
that was the one.
And that ship is crewless.
Yeah, that ship should still be there, right?
No, no, it's just, its sails are down, so it's just being taken out to sea.
And the anchor was up.
It's a ghost ship now.
But there's no crew, so it can't, just gonna fail.
Well, it'll just go until it crashes, yeah, taken by the tides.
And next to it, there's a stone Azrael.
There's crystals on it.
A fishing boat as well, yeah. That'll probably sink first. It's got a heavy statue on it. It's a fishing ship.
Oh. It was a very good episode. I love it. It's like we just watched a whole new series or something. I want more.
Yeah, I want more.
We'll do the training art next. Slash the fallout and feedback from this, and then it'll be the invasion.
Take a look at my WhatsApp, by the way, about dates. Going to do something this year.
Yeah, I'd like to do something in person. I'd sit down, do some Airbnb-ing. Can't stop listening to this song now. It's like a credit song.
Yeah, it's just the sad we lost. Or it's like, we haven't
Oh
lost.
No, he's hot!
Yeah, that's when he was shirtless in the...
What, Xylus?
Yeah. It's like, oh my god, and he's steaming.
Look at those gum gutters.
We did alright. We're all alive.
Yeah.
I have a question for you. Will you ever let one of us die?
Yes.
In a game?
Yes.
Do you already have somebody planned?
No. It was very much like a...
Very much up to us.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You can definitely die. This obviously you go down, just like, Chess, what's your other character called?
Gwen.
Gwen's missing like three fingers, so when you go down, you roll.
Yeah, the one angel dropped to zero, right?
No, I dropped to the three. I don't think I've ever been zero.
You dropped Gwen to zero.
Technically, Lulan's died.
Yeah, Lulan's died, but Lulan has as long as her ults are active, she's got to get out of safety. She died twice. Once to Varys and once to Anarion. Anarion burst.
Anarion was a dream.
Yeah, that doesn't.
Also in the mountains. Remember, your ults were up with the golems, and you were fighting the chaos guys, and then your chest exploded, and then your other clone vomited all the blood back out as its organs formed, and you rushed towards Freya, and the two of you ran away.
I have no memory of this.
I don't remember this at all.
They were on the other side of the battle. It was Freya, the Earth Elemental, and Lulan, and they were closing the far left gate, the Chaos Gate, and you closed it, this massive snowstorm happened, and your three clones were looking at each other, and then a lightning hand exploded through the back, and immediately one of the clones vomited blood, and then its organs formed. Freya activated her ult, and the two of you ran away as Anarion was trying to break it.
Yeah, I do remember.
And then the dwarfs were calling for you in the storm.
I'm sure they were.
I need to remember not to ult.
Well, sometimes it's very useful, and then sometimes it's a complete waste. So yes. you gotta use it wisely. Wisely.
What was your favourite bit, Alex, to wrap up?
Your reaction to your second ult was cool. I liked the flipping off, I'm not gonna lie. I very much was, when I was like, do it, do it. Because if you'd done it, the reaction from Azrael would have been a lot less. His dinner's on me.
Well, with the original, because I really nearly did it when he did his little wink. I was just going to swap places with him then, just to piss him off. But
yeah, he would have killed Clara then. Okay. Or Burns. I'm so glad I didn't do it. But yeah, you gave him enough time to get the seeds.
I did text you saying I wanted to do it before I thought we'd get there, though.
Oh, did you text me?
You responded.
Oh, right, in the chat. Yeah, yeah. Oh, I thought you meant, can we go back to me? I only half read it, sorry.
That's right. I was just going to try and do it logically when I thought he would be able to get to the tower from there and then swap just before he could go. What happens now?
He was already at the tower.
And then I really liked, obviously, Voltrim in his ult fighting. So as the two guys are fist fighting in the background, there's just these almost two deities that have clearly fought over and over again. Also, now you know the existence of outer gods. Not just,
I was gonna say,
Void, who wants to become a god or thinks himself to be a god.
I was gonna say, because Azrael basically hinted at that he is, I don't know, not patron or whatever to an outer god.
Mm-hmm.
He's supported at least by something other.
Mm-hmm.
Folks, I'm gonna have to call it there.
Yeah, no worry, man.
Thank you, Alex.
I love you and leave you. When should we try and do next session?
I'll put it in chat.
Cool.
Come on.
Have a good evening.
Right. And everyone.